It is now live.
Hey everybody, welcome to a very special trailer watch party. We've left the United States. We've left my home office. We're here in Japan at the Trash Taste Pod After Dark set with a very special guest, Garnt.
Wow, thank you very much. That was such a professional introduction. That was way more professional than what I'm used to.
Oh, was it really?
I'm just whenever we go live, I'm just more like, hey guys, it's you know where we are. It's it's a studio.
Well, we're so glad to have you. Thanks for making the time to be with us for the next 3.5 hours.
We're gonna try
to survive about 50 anime trailers for the spring 2024 anime
season. I'm so ready.
And joining us also is Anime News Network's Japan correspondent, Richard Eisenbeis.
I am Richard Eisenbeis, yeah.
Richard has a lot of experience with this because he does the Japanese language version.
Yeah, there's a Japanese version called Suzukimi that's actually happening Friday, but it's the same thing, only all in Japanese.
Right.
Why?
So I would be completely lost if I was on the set for that one.
But honestly, this is looking to be a lot more chill. I'm super excited for it.
Yeah. We've got comfy couches, much better than our office chairs, you know, that we've got at home. So I want to say thank you to the audience for joining us. Mm-hmm. And before we get started, I got to do a couple little plugs here. If you enjoy this stream, Anime News Network has the ANN After Show, and that is on Tuesdays at 6 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Eastern every week, where we talk about the latest anime season, new shows, and news to keep you up to date. So please, you know, come back and tune in for that. I also got to give a shout out that this Trailer Watch Party is sponsored. So I want to give a thank you to iBuyPower.com, Atsuko, who gave us the cool threads that Richard and I are wearing today, and also to Viz. So before we get started on our first trailer, also, you're going to want to make sure that you have snacks and water because this is going to go for a while.
Yes.
So you want to get comfortable, make sure that, you know, you've got your favorite foods to accompany you. So before we get to the first trailer, though, we do have a special ad from one of our sponsors. This is for Viz Media for their One Piece collection.
Ooh.
Awesome. Also, what we plan to do at the end of this, and it'd be fun if the rest of you could come along with us, is that we're going to make a list of our top 5 trailers when this all wraps up and which ones we think look the most promising for the next season.
Right.
Before we get started, Garnt, are there any that you're already kind of hyped for?
I mean, my audience knows I am an absolute fiend for isekai.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yes, I am that person.
Okay.
So I know there's a lot of big profile sequels that are coming next season. Konosuba. Oh, yeah. That time I got reincarnated as a slime, Mushoku Tensei. But in terms of new IPs, I know Kaiju number 8 is coming out next
year.
Yeah,
I think there's a lot of hype for that one. I'm looking forward to that one too. Richard, are there any that you're already kind of got your eye on?
Aside from sequels, Go Go Loser Ranger.
Yes, right.
I'm super pumped. And I'm sure we'll talk more about that
when we get to the trailer.
For sure.
Well, let's dive right into this because we've got quite a playlist to go through. So let's start with our first trailer. This is a sequel.
Right.
We're starting up with some easy vibes. Let's get with Laid Back Camp Season 3. Oh, this is not Laid Back Camp Season 3.
Yeah.
This is Mysterious Disappearances.
Yes.
Oops. Okay. Maybe those got switched around. I don't know as much about this one other than the fact that it, you know, it's a mystery series about an aspiring novelist and the ghost stories, urban legends, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I remember I recognized this one immediately because I actually had to announce this one at last year's AX. And it's, from what I understand, it's a new adaptation and it's, like you said, a mystery series. I'm not sure if it's going to be pure mystery or if there's going to be some kind of horror aspect to it. But it seems kind of similar to something on the lines of kind of like Monogatari.
I'm a horror fan myself, so if it brings the spookiness, I'll definitely want to check it out.
Yeah,
certainly suspense.
Yeah. The animation actually looks really good, though, too. Like, yeah, that's been one of the things that's been hard with the mystery series or horror is that they tend to not have the greatest production values, but this looks good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Colors are a little washed out, but yeah, that might be a benefit.
Yeah.
As far as the tone goes.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Nice that this one has subtitles on it, too. I tried to pick as many trailers as subtitles as possible, just so our US-based readers or watchers could follow along. Yeah. It's kind of a bop. All right, that was Mysterious Disappearances.
Yeah. Is there only one trailer we're watching for each show?
Yeah, we'll do.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
It would extend the length quite a bit if we did like every
trailer. Yeah, because like, I know some trailers have like multiple trailers that come out for every show.
I try to do the most recent one when we can.
Yeah.
There are a couple in here that aren't the most recent just because of when they came out when I got to Japan and
right.
So from an organizational angle. But we can go on to the next one. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. So, okay. Yeah, we've already got that.
Okay,
thank you. All right, we're going to the next trailer.
Oh.
This one is titled Train to the End of the World. It's going to stream on Crunchyroll.
Yes, this one I'm actually very excited about. I'll hold my tongue until the end of the trailer.
Oh, okay.
But,
I know that the director of this is the same director as Girls in Ponzer.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is an original, right?
This is an original, which is one of the reasons why I'm very, very excited.
Yeah.
So this trailer, I actually watched this trailer before. Doesn't give away too much.
Yeah.
So at first I was like, is this a Girls Last Tour kind of vibe? Okay. Because if you look at the title, it's Train to the End of the World.
Right? Yeah,
so I was
like,
post-apocalyptic kind of world. But I'm not sure if there's something more going on.
Yeah, it kind of is giving me a little bit of like School Live vibe.
Yes, that's exactly what I was thinking. Yes, yes.
Where it's like, oh, it looks really cute, but maybe someone's actually dead the whole time.
What a great first episode that was.
Yeah.
Oh man, good old Gakkogarashi.
Yeah. And you know what I love about anime originals is that there's no manga or light novel readers who is like, oh, I know what's going to happen, actually.
Yeah, no, you can't get spoiled on social media.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
There's a dog.
Of course, there's a dog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, that felt like a little creepy stinger.
Yeah.
At the end there.
There was just watching that trailer, it's like most of it is like happy-go-lucky vibes, right. Slice of lifey, cute girls. And I was like, ah, okay, Girls Last Tour again. I got it. And then some of the shots, you can feel the air just like being a bit off, you know? So I feel like there's something more going on. This is going to be something I'm going to have to watch for like a few episodes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if we get that last 30-second twist at the end of the first episode.
Exactly.
Yeah. I don't trust it. I'm already very suspicious of what might be going on in there.
Yeah. But I'm excited. I love when a trailer doesn't give away too much.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
When they don't put all the best bits, they do that with movie trailers too, where they put all the like best bits at the beginning and like, well, now what's left to keep me in time.
It's certainly a hard, I mean, I think it's an art making a trailer
is. It is.
Especially because I know that like usually they get a certain amount of footage and they're just told, here, make something interesting out of this. And they're never able to get more or anything. And they just kind of have to build a puzzle around it.
Right.
So yeah, I mean, I think pretty good job on like leaving the hint in there, but
yeah. Well, that's me assuming, you know, maybe it's just a slice of life. I could be wrong. I could be wrong.
But it could just be girls on a train, but it does look kind of post-apocalyptic sort of. There was like a shot of the inside of the train where it showed all this
like vines and
stuff growing on it. You're like, this has definitely been abandoned or something. Like,
I've seen too many shows not to trust it anymore.
All right, so to move on to the next trailer, this one looks, I think, more like a comedy maybe a little bit of romance in there, but I think it's comedy first. And this is A Salad Bowl of Eccentrics is the localized title. Oh,
I love
title.
The name.
Okay. But she's reading Detective Conan.
Oh.
Since we don't have subtitles, I'll explain a little bit of what's supposed to be going on here. The main male character is a detective. And then right. He meets this girl, Sarah Da Odin. And she's a princess from another world with magical powers.
Of course, of course.
And they start living together. And then you get more strange characters kind of showing up. So I guess a little, what's that show? That's the reverse isekai where they work at McDonald's. Devil is a part-timer.
Devil is part-timer, yes.
Yeah, sort of like that. There's a female knight, a real estate agent. No, a divorce agent, sorry. Religious leader, a lawyer.
She must be a detective. She just summoned the Detective Conan theme.
Yeah. Somebody clearly did a good job of getting the rights.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, like with, what was it? Uncle from Another World, how they got all the Sega rights.
Oh, yeah. Right? That was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that looked like your, you know, cutesy, happy-go-lucky, slice-of-lifey kind of show.
Yeah.
With a little bit of a twist.
I think it'll hinge on the charm of the main character. She won me over a little bit in the trailer, though. So.
I wonder if how much you enjoy Detective Conan will affect how much you enjoy it.
Right.
Because there were some serious in-jokes in there with, like, the glasses and stuff like that.
Detective Conan struggled, at least in the U.S. a little bit, to really, like, find a foundation in most anime watchers. I mean, there's definitely a fandom.
Of course. Yes,
just,
of course.
It's not just not the same as Japan, right?
Yeah.
So. Maybe that might be a hard sell.
Yeah, I mean, I think with the Detective Conan thing, it could be much bigger in Japan and Asia in general, because I know how big it is here. Didn't so much, as you said, make an impact in the West as much as they did in Asia. But yeah, this depends on, I think, the chemistry of the cast.
Yeah,
because we saw a lot of cast members, and I think that's gonna be a big factor in how good the show is.
Right.
Yeah, it's ensemble comedy for sure.
Yep.
All right, this next one will also be streaming on Crunchyroll, and it's called God's Games We Play. All that I kind of got out of it is it's got a... Nope, this is...
Oh, this is Seventh Prince.
This is Seventh Prince, okay. I was reincarnated as the Seventh Prince, so I got to focus on my magic, I think is what it was.
I think I've read part of this.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember. Is this... I think this is the one where he thinks he can live a free life because he's the Seventh Prince.
Right, but... yeah. None of that pressure to be the heir sort of thing, right?
Right.
Or even the backup heir or the backup heir.
I know this has got... This has got a little bit of a dedicated fan base.
Does it?
I've heard people talk about this before.
The demon's cool looking.
I mean, the vibe of this kind of show, when it comes to, you know, we've seen this kind of show before where it's like an overpowered
one.
An eighth prince or eighth princess or something.
Yeah.
You have probably an overpowered main protagonist. And it really much depends on my enjoyment of a lot of these kinds of shows. Normally depends on how much fun they have with it or how much like self-awareness there is.
Yeah.
And I think with this show, from what I've heard, is that they really delve into just like, okay, we know what this kind of show is. Let's just go over the top and just have fun with it.
Right. It does seem like they've gone all in with it. You've seen some of these where it kind of seems like they're phoning it in even production-wise, but I was impressed by the visuals there.
Yeah.
Quite a bit.
Yeah, I found the more over the top, the better, like with being reincarnated as a vending machine.
Yeah, it turned out
to be an actually a really fun little show.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, if you go far enough, it can be really fun.
Yeah. I just wanted to make a quick aside to we've got some folks in the back. I don't know if those two trailers that I've mentioned so far are missing, but if those could get added to the playlist, I'd still like to include them. So
yeah, and it looks like we're about to skip another one right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm keeping a list in case we need to go back.
Yeah.
The ones we skipped.
Okay, yeah, because I definitely double checked these ahead of time, so I don't know if something got moved around by someone else who may have access to it. So
Okay.
So this next one is from Kyoto Animation. It's a long-awaited sequel. It's been a number of years since we've returned.
How many years?
To Sound Euphonium.
Yes.
This is on my backlog, so I'm going to need you guys to fill in on Sound Euphonium.
I think it's been 8 years since I have seen the... I haven't seen season two. I do need to catch up to season two, but it's been 8 years since I think I saw the original one, so it's been a very, very long time. But I'm excited to see Kyoto Animation come back in general, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. I saw the first season.
Yeah.
I saw Liz and the Bluebird.
Oh, I haven't seen Liz and the Bluebird.
And I really did enjoy Liz and the Bluebird.
Yeah.
It actually, I think it was, I preferred it actually over the general Sound Euphonium. But yeah, it was an interesting side story, but like I knew some of the characters, so it all kind of fit together in a really cool way.
Right.
But yeah, this one looks like what? Passing of the Torch?
Yeah. Mm.
She's about to graduate. There's a new Euphonium player.
Yeah.
Did either of you play instruments in band in high school?
Clarinet and violin.
Did you really?
Yeah.
I only played guitar back in school, but that was mostly as a hobby. I didn't join any clubs or anything like that.
I did a little bit of piano when I was very young and had a brief stint on a saxophone that I don't want to talk about.
Right.
Get very far with that.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, I mean, I'm just very excited to see Kyoto Animation back.
Yeah.
It feels good, you know, after the, you know, horrible events that happened, but it's good to see them getting back on their feet and making a sequel to I think one of their most beloved franchise. I know a lot of people love Sound Euphonium a lot.
Yeah, it's got some diehard fans in there, so it'll be exciting to see the story reach its conclusion. This next one we have seems like a kind of a slower series. This is about yokai. This is Tonari no Youkai-san. It's about a village, small town that has a lot of yokai residents in it. So, yeah, let's take a look at this one.
Zero! Oh, Mu-chan.
It's just cute.
Oh.
Yeah.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
Nekomata?
Boku wa nekomata ni narimashita. Shabette.
I don't know how you become a two-tailed cat, but okay. Yeah.
They have to live about 100 years or something like that. If your cat manages to live 100 years, it'll become a nekomata and it grows a second tail. Ghost?
Oh.
Ghost, maybe?
Oh.
Slice of life.
This is.
Or Iyashike, maybe. Yeah. It seems like a lot of emotional.
Kind of seems almost like a Ghibli-esque atmosphere as well. You know what I mean?
Or family drama.
Yeah.
Different people living together.
Yeah.
Becoming a found family.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, I feel a lot better just watching that.
Yeah.
My day is already better.
I feel healed.
Yeah.
Can we take a quick moment? Because this is completely out of order. And I'm not sure why, because now we're skipping one, two others to get to this one, and I'm not.
Yeah.
Chris, do you have the YouTube playlist open? Can you take a look at that? I think what we'll do is we'll mark these, and then we'll take an intermission after we get to halfway point, and I'll add them so that we can just move them into the middle.
Sounds good.
Yeah. So I'm not sure what happened.
Yeah, I'm keeping that. A check here of everyone we skip.
Okay, thank you, Richard. Yeah. All right, so this next one is based off a webtoon, which we're seeing more of those lately. Anime series, Solo Leveling probably being the most popular one.
We had Solo Leveling. I know we had a regression one 2 seasons ago or something like that as well.
There's been a villainess one as well.
And a villainess one.
Yeah.
These are the originals from Crunchyroll?
No, these are a series based off Korean comics. Korean comics.
Yeah. Well, yeah, we also had then Tower of God.
Yeah.
What was the
God of High School?
God of High School. I mean, it's funny, in the recent years, I've actually gotten more and more into the Korean.
Oh, same here, yeah.
But mostly for me, it's I just love that they crank out villainous stories like it's gone out of style.
Yeah.
If you're an isekai guy, I'm a villainous guy. I read all of them. Anyone I can get, I love them all.
Yeah.
You like the format too, where it's more like scrolling on your phone, right? For a lot of these.
Yeah.
I don't particularly care.
Yeah,
which way it is?
I prefer, because when I read manga, I very much like a physical volume. I'm very old school in that sense. I can't read manga on my phone; that just doesn't work. But with web comics, it's so much more easier just to read on your phone and more casual.
Yeah,
and I can more easily immerse myself in the story. Whereas I'm always waiting for the physical release if it's a manga.
Yeah, that's true. If it's a manga these days, most of the time I'd read that on a pad.
Yeah,
right. But if it's a webtoon, I have no problem scrolling it on my
phone. Exactly.
Yeah,
so this one is called Viral Hit, and it's about a scrawny high school student, last person you'd expect to star in a new tube channel, and it revolves around fighting. So let's see him take a couple hits.
YouTube, is it?
Yeah, that's what they do on YouTube, right? Hit each other, wear chicken masks. Hey, yo. Are you ready or not?
Getting to Korean manhwa, a lot of them do have this bullying trope.
So it's Fight Club, but in the modern day.
Yeah, pretty much.
Not what I go to YouTube for. I'm one of those people, I can't handle the prank videos and stuff like that, because I relate too much to a person being taken advantage of. So,
well, the one thing I know about self defense YouTube is that you can't trust 90% of self defense YouTubers.
I've seen all the debunking ones. It's gonna kill yourself. Yeah. What? No,
This does not apply to real life.
Right. Don't do this. You will die. Please.
I'm just saying, if I was getting beaten up in school, would I trust the guy in a chicken mask to
teach
me how to fight?
No. Yeah, I don't think that was for me personally.
I mean, it looks like a fun kind of turn your brain off kind of show where you're like, okay.
It's clearly a root for the little guy, right?
Yeah.
Were you the little guy? Are you an anime watcher? You probably were the little guy. So let's live vicariously through this power fantasy.
Yeah.
All right. This next one is about golf, specifically disgraced. Richard, why don't you introduce this one? Because you read the first manga.
Read the first volume of this, and actually got to interview some of the cast members this last week. But yeah, this is if I was going to introduce this, I'd say imagine Barakamon, only golf instead of calligraphy.
Okay.
So it's a disgraced PGA guy, goes to an island off the coast of Japan, and meets a young girl prodigy.
I see. Okay.
So it's kind of like one of those father-daughter kind of relationships that form.
Form between, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, well, the last golf anime I watched was Birdie Wing, which I very much enjoyed.
Yeah, Birdie Wing's a whole different this
seems,
vibe, though.
Yeah, yeah, this seems like it's going to be totally different from that.
Yes. Little googly eyes.
Yeah.
And they're cute.
Yeah, oh, yeah, she's the, like, soul girl, soul child on the island.
Oh, really? So it's, like...
Oh, this is totally Barakamon vibes.
Right. Yeah, yeah, of course, like the whole first chapter of the manga, he has no idea that she's a girl.
Oh, really?
Right.
Yeah.
Thinks it's just young guy.
They have a golf course on this island, though?
That's kind of the secret. Yes, there's like a full golf course on the island.
Okay.
Oh, to keep a secret is golf courses aren't the easiest thing to build.
Yeah. Right, right. Especially like... These are like they go into big detail about how hard it is to get to these islands because they are real. They do exist. The island does. And yeah, getting out there is like a 3-day ordeal because it's plane to boat.
Right.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was the sea too rough? Guess what? You're stuck there for a week. And there are actually a fair amount of these kind of islands in Japan that are like that. Sparsely populated. And if the sea acts up, you're not going there.
Oh, well, I just received your Amazon Prime delivery from last year. We got your golf clubs, finally.
We could start there on this. There's like an extended voice actor part of this. Yeah. That's why it goes on for like 5 minutes. But yeah, so that's Oi Tonbo. I don't think the streaming has been announced for that one yet, but it looks cute, especially if, you know, you just want...
Yeah,
you know,
I love those kinds
sort of sports.
Mm. I love the Barakamon vibes as well.
Yeah,
yeah, it very much like at least the first chapter or so was very, very, very Barakamon vibes.
Yeah,
which is not a bad thing. I absolutely love Barakamon. Yeah.
This next one is a sequel. Are you guys familiar with Touken Ranbu?
Yeah. Where swords are also familiar men? With it.
Yeah, so this is...
Anthropomorphic sword boys.
Yes.
Anthropomorphic, they're the spirits of these ancient swords. And
that belong to famous Japanese figures.
Yeah,
figures.
Exactly. And there seems to be a time travel element in this one, I think. This is supposed to take place during the Honnouji incident, which might be more well known to Japanese folks, but that's when... Oda Nobunaga, I believe, was killed.
Yep, was assassinated.
Was assassinated.
Burned in a fire.
All I know is there are a lot of pretty boys in Touken Ranbu.
Yes, yes.
That would be the point.
Yes, yes.
Like if the Fate series is, you know, historical figures,
yes,
mostly is pretty girls. Don't get me wrong, there's plenty of guy characters too. Yeah. But yeah, you know, that's the big catch for that. This is, yeah, swords reimagined
as pretty boys. Mm. Yeah.
All right, and, here we go.
It works. It hits its female audience.
It does.
Hard. Here in Japan.
Yeah, it inspired like a whole movement. Like they started restoring ancient swords and whatnot, and a lot of the fundraising was pushed by the female fans of this franchise.
Oh, wow.
And I mean, they're pretty.
What we've had, like, has it been three previous series?
Yes.
Two previous or three? I'm not
this
sure.
This one,
which.
I believe, is connected to the Hagu Tetsuki, I think is what it was called, something like that. Related to that, which I believe was two movies, but there was also been a
couple
there's
been
anime
a serious series. I know there was a kind of lighter slice of life series as well.
Did Studio Youphonium animate some of their previous
series? Yeah, one of them was.
Yeah. This looks like a different studio, though.
Yeah, this doesn't look like Youphonium.
Doesn't look bad though.
No,
yeah, doesn't look bad.
It's just not.
I mean,
that the Euphotable bar is just there. You know,
right, you know what it is. Like, like one frame. You know.
Yeah.
Oh man, that guy seemed mad. All right. So yeah, that is a Touken Ranbu Kai Kyoden Moyuru Honnouji. So we'll take a quick break here. because we have an ad from one of our sponsors from
Weekend Watch Plans. Grab the latest gear from Atsuko, your go-to for comfy and stylish anime apparel. Whether you're binge-watching the classics or catching up on the latest releases, Atsuko has the perfect gear for watch parties. Visit Atsuko.com for your new weekend favorites.
Yeah, so that was Atsuko. Yep. We are wearing them right now. I've got this great Hunter Hunter sweatshirt in, I guess you'd say it's camel. And Richard, camel. Okay. Camel is what I would call this color. And
okay.
Richard's decked yep. out in a skin tight turtleneck.
Ooh. Yeah, bleach.
From bleach.
Bleach.
From bleach. Yeah. From bleach.
Hell yeah.
So there
got
we go.
On it. Yeah, yeah.
Stand up.
Okay, yeah, go on, go on.
Yeah, yeah. All right,
give us a twirl.
I can
yeah.
give a twirl.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, long sleeves.
Ooh. Ooh. Yeah.
So thanks to Atsuko for the smoking hot gear. Yeah, they've got a big they've got a big variety too. I know they've got some new Berserk stuff out. If you head over to their website, that looks pretty neat. They've got One Piece, a lot of the big Shonen Jump properties. So give them a look if you're looking to get your spring wardrobe going. You too can be hot like Richard.
Oh yeah.
All right, our next trailer. We are blazing through these guys. I actually got like 8 pages, so
okay.
Oh, Nicholas Dupree, freelancer for Anime News Network, would like to know how many super. I don't know, Richard. What's your price?
My price?
Yeah. What's your price? How many super likes do we got to get for you to remove the jacket?
Remove the jacket.
Just and do the it jacket. Like this? Just the jacket.
How much do we get per super like?
I feel like it's like $5.
Okay.
It's around
okay.
$5.
So, oh, 3.
All right.
With three super likes, I'll ditch
$15,
the jacket.
Richard will take off his jacket. I trust.
It's a jacket.
That's a good deal. That's a good deal, guys.
That's a good deal.
Three super likes.
Just throw those in there. I trust our tech team to let us know when the money shows up. Come on. All right. This next one is Chillin' in Another World with level 2 super cheat powers. Ah, okay. So this is for Garnt.
Oh, yes. from level 2, yeah. From
yeah, level two.
Well, I've never seen a level 2 power up before.
Yeah.
Normally it all starts at level 1.
Yeah, I've read this one.
Oh, you've read this
yeah.
one?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of that twist of like at level 1, he basically has no cheat abilities. He looks like a total garbage character.
Right.
Like a total garbage guy. But at level 2, that's when he gets his cheat abilities. And so it's kind of, he has that freedom
right.
from already of being deemed useless.
Okay.
I'm sure that's the demon lord.
Yes.
One with the cat aspect.
Of course, there's the elf. The mage. Big dark
hat,
elf.
Big witch hat. That's for me.
Damn, they're bringing out all the archetypes yeah, for this. Every yes. single isekai archetype you can think of.
There's a girl here for everyone, essentially, right?
Pretty much.
There is a girl here yeah. for everyone. In fact, we've seen so many at this point.
I don't think there's been a single frame with more than one character we've just seen before. For now.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel like we've seen at least 8 girls
yeah.
at this point.
I just realized she has 2 sets of ears and that weirds me out.
Oh, that bothers me. You either get with the animal ears or the human ears. You don't do both.
I didn't notice that. Now I won't be able to unsee it. Ever.
Yeah. Maybe it's just supposed to be
oh,
like...
Oh, yeah, you're right. Oh, I can't unsee it now.
Maybe it's just supposed to be like a
maybe it's supposed to be hair.
Yeah.
Maybe it is supposed to be hair.
Maybe.
Not ears.
Maybe it's just an aesthetic, you know?
Yeah.
Maybe...
Okay. Well, that was a thing, right?
Yeah, I mean, for a lot of these isekai things, normally I pick like one as like my, you know, McDonald's comfort food
yeah,
where I'm like
yeah.
I know this isn't too healthy for me but yeah. something to put on while I eat lunch
yeah, my chicken nuggets
yeah. I mean, the thing with isekai in general, since it's so I don't overplayed, but I don't mean that in a bad way. Yeah. Just yeah. so done so much so often.
Yeah.
Is like it all hinges on that twist. And can you make your little tiny twist interesting?
Yeah. Right.
Like if you can fully explore that twist, you can have a really fun show.
Yeah.
The problem is sometimes the twist is just an excuse to replay every other trope that's ever been done before. And that's where I think the problem comes.
Yeah. A lot of the times it's like, okay, we do this twist. We explore it for one episode. I watch it for one episode. And then after that one episode, it's like, okay, now let's just go back to being every your standard isekai that everyone else has already done.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
But if you really stick with it, you can get some really cool stuff.
Yeah.
Well, you said you've read that one, Richard. So do you think that one, did you keep reading it?
I read a large chunk of it.
Yeah.
But I don't, but I haven't gone back to it recently. Mm,
okay.
I don't think, but it certainly wasn't bad, because if it was bad, I never would have gotten.
Sure.
Even like five chapters in, I would have just dropped it.
Yeah. Yeah.
But no, I certainly remember reading a sizable amount and being introduced to a large amount of the cast, but.
Okay.
You know.
Okay. All right, so this next one, it's original property. This is 3D CG. Don't everyone groan at once, but this is 3D CG anime about racing.
Okay.
So, yeah, let's take a look at Highspeed Etoile. It's French. Okay. I'm sorry.
Yeah, sure. We'll go with that.
Yeah. That sounds.
That's exactly what it is. That's perfect because I don't speak any French. So yeah. I am 100% certain in my assertion.
I appreciate your support.
I'm English, so if we get French things wrong, I'm proud. I'm proud of us.
It was all on purpose the whole time. It wasn't ignorance. Yeah. It was willful.
All right, guys. I think we can groan now.
Okay.
Just saw the background shots for this. I'm sorry,
Sega. Is that
Sega.
Actual Sega?
That yeah, it did say chill out, relaxation on her helmet there.
Well, are these real companies that they got to sponsor this? Because I see YoStar.
Yeah. I think it is.
I don't know. I'm not so hard on 3D anime. Like I've seen some really horrible looking 3D anime, and this doesn't even fit like the top 100 terrible 3D anime I've seen in my lifetime. So
I'll tell you what this feels like. What? This feels like a gacha game adaptation.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like when
I am thinking that there is probably some sort of game tie-in to this.
Yeah.
Lorenzo.
I mean, in these wide shots, you wouldn't even think it was 3D.
Yeah,
I agree.
I mean, I think the quality of 3D in general has just improved a lot in 3D CG anime.
Yeah.
Fortunately, this one looks a little bit middle of the road in terms of quality.
Yeah.
In terms of 3D quality.
And I think we're getting to the point where people don't even notice when it is 3D.
Yeah.
And so they complain when they see 3D, but it's like bad 3D is the 3D you can notice.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, this one I felt like the worst part of it was actually more the background art issues. Like, I feel like that was what was taking.
Oh yeah, look
out.
At all those. I didn't.
Yeah.
I didn't mind the character 3D. It was actually more the racing parts that looks a little bit off to me.
I'm sorry. I like that.
Yeah. Yeah. That was. Yeah. Her car is supposed to have AI. I think.
Yeah.
So there's probably like a.
Oh, so it's Knight Rider Racing. Okay.
Yeah.
Suddenly I'm like five times more interested than I was 30 seconds ago. That's great.
The main character is also supposed to, before getting into racing, she was a neat. So.
Of course. Of course.
Wow. Well, which is a kind of a.
She just like me.
For real. Yeah. All right. So this is another reincarnation isekai. This is. As a reincarnated aristocrat, I'll use my appraisal skill. I think, Richard, you're familiar with
this. No, I really love this. Oh, okay. I love this manga.
Well, let's see how the anime adaptation turned out.
See, this is the kind of isekai I like, where it's like a different twist to it, where he's using his like appraisal skills.
And his appraisal skill, this isn't like appraising items.
Yeah.
It's appraising people. So he can look at you and he can see your like current proficiencies in certain areas and what your max is as well.
Yeah.
So he can see a person and go, oh, you could become like the greatest wizard in the world.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But sees them trying to learn how to use a sword and can be like, help guide them in certain ways.
It's like you can see their little stat thing.
Right. Yeah. So it's like their max and then they're where they are currently.
Okay. Yes.
And it's it turns to be a really kind of heartfelt thing where the trick is, of course, he can't appraise himself. He has no idea how he actually factors into the whole situation.
Right.
So he constantly suffers from an inferiority complex.
Oh, okay.
Because he finds all these great talented people who think the world of him.
Yeah.
But not him. But he doesn't think anything of himself.
Oh, right.
Okay. For those keeping count, we're at Lynzee Big Hat Counter 2.
Yes.
This is important. Big witch hats.
Yeah. And so it's pretty kind of like heartfelt kind of show about like one good person helping everybody become better versions of themselves.
Yeah.
So
he's a life coach, basically.
In an interesting way, because he really does can help them find happiness.
Yeah. Oh,
okay.
And there's interesting things like, what do the stats necessarily mean? Like, what does political acumen really mean? Does that mean you're like a psychopath?
Yeah.
You can say anything or what? Like, and he has to kind of, figure it out little by little as he meets these people and gets to know them.
Okay. Yeah, that was probably any sky I've most interested in that we've seen so far. Something that's a little bit different and a little, a new concept that I don't think has been so explored before.
Yeah, and I think it does a really good job of like looking at like the outer implications, because what happens when you have this like kind of backwater lord who's like this young kid heir who suddenly starts recruiting people who quickly become the strongest magician?
Paying attention.
You start worrying about, is this kid about trying to usurp the empire? Like that kind of thing. And so it's an interesting thing of how like they really do a good job of like the implications behind the thing, which is what I was talking about earlier. The twist.
Right.
Like if you take your twist to the extreme, that's when you start to get something enjoyable. And I'm not saying it's like the best show ever created or anything like that, but I read it every time a new issue comes out.
Yeah. It's
a quick check-in. How's our super chats going? Zero super chats.
It's okay.
Wow.
It's okay. I thank you.
Okay.
I thank you.
Okay.
Good job, guys. Keep the super chats not coming.
Yeah. I thought we'd at least get one in there from Nicholas. Nick.
Yeah. Not putting his money where his mouth is.
Right. Yeah. You'll be getting an email later. Okay. This next one's going to stream on High Dive. It's an original project. And this is Jellyfish Can't Swim in the Night.
Ooh.
Kind of mysterious sort of title. My understanding about the overall plot is these are all girls who kind of had artistic dreams that they had to abandon for various reasons.
I really love the aesthetic of this.
Yeah, coming together to fulfill their artistic dreams.
Yeah. Is this an anime original also?
Yes, yeah. As far as I know, it's not based on anything like a manga or light novel or game.
All right, well, I'm already watching it.
Yeah.
The directing and aesthetics of this look very, very good.
Yes.
Almost bocce-esque, but kind of...
Yeah, I can see that.
A little bit of bocce, a little bit of... what's that Cloverworks anime with the girls?
Kirabaku? No, that's
a Cloverworks. Cloverworks. Yeah. It was also an anime original. I'm going to Google this right now.
Okay, sure, yeah. I like all the nighttime scenes, too.
Yeah.
That vibe.
Yeah, if you're talking about backgrounds, this is... got some serious detail in the background.
Yeah. And it looks like there's a lot of like personal drama.
There's some really creative camera shots there too.
Yeah.
The directors, who is the director of this? They're doing a good job.
What studio is this?
I'm going to open up the Anime News Network encyclopedia page for Jellyfish Can't Swim at Night. It's not in notes.
Mm.
That was a very, very that was a very impressive trailer.
Hey Matt, can you open up the encyclopedia? Oh, okay, Chris has got it.
Fantastic.
Yeah, we want. Okay. Oh, Doga Kobo. Okay.
I was gonna say One Drake Priority was like it was like One Drake Priority and Bocchi kind of like mixing together. Yeah. I'm very, very interested in that one. The directing seems very, very good.
What are you guys getting up to back there? We got 12 bucks. 12 bucks. We only need three more dollars, guys. $3 more for Richard to remove his jacket.
Did Nick put his money where his mouth was?
Nicholas, I'm so disappointed in you.
I mean, good job the rest of you picking up his slack, but
yeah.
Well, you better pay it. Yeah. Already did. Are we at 15? Have we officially at 15?
Chris, did you put any of that money in there? No, not yet.
Not yet.
Oh, okay. Okay. Thanks, Demon Hero.
All right.
Jellyfish Can't Swim at Night. I think that one looks pretty promising. No.
I also see one of the characters. So it's a lot of artists who are the main characters for Jellyfish Can't Swim at Night.
Yeah.
One of the characters is also meant to be a VTuber, which.
Oh, okay.
So it's their different art forms. That's kind of.
Yeah,
cool.
That's. I don't think I've seen like a VTuber in an anime yet. Mostly when I see VTubers in anime, it's more like, hey, we are actually part of like an idol agency. So just having like a VTuber as a part of like a. I assume that to be like a drama kind of like story. Yeah. I don't think I've seen that before. So I think that would be pretty interesting.
Yeah, because the only thing I could think of was the, what was it? The Kizuna Ai.
Yeah.
Anime. That's the only one I can.
That's the only one as well. And
one of the girls in Oshinoko is a VTuber. No,
she's a YouTuber.
She's a YouTuber. Right.
All right, so this next one is Girls Band Cry. And then we're going to take a quick break so I can correct some of the trailer order issues we're having, because now we're skipping another three.
Oh,
okay.
And I want to fix it.
Oh boy.
All right.
Yeah, see what happened there. All right. So this is Girls Band Cry. This is from Toei Animation, and it's a kind of got it's 3D CG, and it reminds me a little bit. What was that really popular? God, I'm drawing a blank. Everyone put it on the like their top of the season. It was a season or so ago at ANN, and it's based on a franchise that has a mobile game.
Bang Dream.
So this kind of give me Bang Dream vibes, but let's see how it looks. That looks like someone's real fingers who is typing that in there.
That feels weird.
Doesn't it? Yeah.
Ooh, I like the facial expressions.
This is the Ruby School of animation here.
Ruby School?
This is a lot like how they do the animated faces for Ruby.
Yeah. Oh, Ruby.
Okay. I already like it because sometimes when you see 3D CG, the facial expressions are the things that look the most static.
Yeah.
And I remember, I think it was Trigun Stampede last year where Studio Orange really did such good work with the micro expressions.
Yeah.
And there seems to be a lot of work put into the expressions in this one as well.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, like that's actually really interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm kind of vibing with this one.
Yeah, I'd like to hear like a real needle drop though.
Yeah. Also, I'm a sucker for rock anime and music anime, so this and the last show are just totally my vibe.
Okay. I do think the facial expressions are pretty fun.
Yeah, look at that.
Yeah, so that one looks like it's about, what is it? The thing says it's about three girls who are like abandoned, like either by their parents or their friends or their something. And so they're all kind of like disillusioned and then come together and form a band.
Okay.
Nice.
I mean, I'm sold. Yeah. Like I said, a big thing was like the 3D CG. Can they get like the facial expressions down? It looks like they did. And that looked like on the upper end of like good quality 3D CG. Yeah. So
yeah,
I'm excited for that one. Yeah.
All right. We're going to take a quick break so I can check some technical stuff on here. So we make sure we get you guys all the trailers that we promised. So stick around and we will be right back.
I'm going to take a quick Twitter break.
Yeah, because we skipped five right there.
Yeah, we're skipping a whole bunch from the playlist, so.
Oh, maybe they were moved to Crunchyroll.
I just need to look at the YouTube playlist to see if certain videos are even in it.
All right, so which, is there an intermission?
I don't have an intermission.
So it's going to be Richard, just Richard there. I've muted everything, so.
Okay, so he's just muted. Okay, yeah. That's fine.
Yeah. Okay,
so,
yeah, Laid Back Camp was the first. The second was God's Games We Play. The third was Oblivion Battery.
Okay. Hold on, I don't have it open yet.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Yeah, this one skipped like this is skipping three.
Yeah, so I don't know what's going on with that, but I need to fix it.
Yeah, is it possible to manually select them and then make it big?
I don't hold on.
Yeah, it's not there on the list.
Okay, I have a suspicion.
What?
I mentioned Crunchyroll trailers. Crunchyroll might have removed all those trailers.
Oh! Why would they do that?
No. Okay, so if it's Crunchyroll, Crunchyroll trailers are blocked in Japan.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you have to use a VPN or just watch the Japanese trailers.
Okay. They won't have subtitles. I need to go through and basically manually. I didn't at all.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. I should have said that. I didn't think about it because it's just kind of normal.
Yeah.
Do you have a VPN on that?
Not on this PC.
I don't want to pull from like unofficial sources.
No. Okay, so that's Ji-chan kara moratta. God's Games We Play.
Okay.
Oh, the train won't leave them.
Yes, it did. Well, it just says Crunchyroll next to it because that they're streaming it.
Oh, okay.
That IGN one at the top would be official.
Okay.
Because it's IGN.
Okay, and then what was next?
Oblivion Battery.
Okay.
Yeah, it is most of the Crunchyroll ones.
Yeah, that's what it is.
But not all of them. That's always interesting.
Yeah.
This is one from Kadokawa. 3 months old. Let's do. Okay. This one.
Kizunaga.
Okay.
Okay.
After Oblivion's Battery.
The banished former hero lives as he pleases.
Wait, is this
yours?
That's my
son.
Yeah, sorry.
I think it really depends on if it's a Crunchyroll trailer that was on the playlist.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because we did have some.
Yeah.
Like Sound Euphonium.
Sound Euphonium, I think, was on the Kyoto Animation channel. Is anything on the Crunchyroll channel?
Yeah, I'd forgotten about that.
Okay, this one's on MAL, so that's good.
Yeah, that'd be fine. That means it's official. The next one is A Condition Called Love.
Okay,
yeah, DMM will be the official.
Okay, and then
Windbreaker.
That's the official one.
Okay.
The next one is Tadaima Okaeri. That's what it's called. Tadaima Okaeri.
FAQ title.
Yeah,
there we go.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, that's one.
Okay, and Remonster.
Yeah.
Why don't you go back for a while and do a short, a second short intermission later instead of a long intermission now?
Yeah, we're about to. We have one more to add from that. Because we'll have to do this again.
Because I don't know which ones we'll skip after this.
Yeah.
Okay, and then the Irregular or Magic High School.
Season 3, yeah.
No. I mean, I know I put comments on which ones we're streaming, but I don't remember.
Boy, that's tough. Did you put 3? Season 3? There we go.
2 months ago, Aniplex.
Yeah, that'll be fine.
Okay, so what I need you to basically do is go to the bottom and start here.
Something there.
Yep, and then it should be...
Okay, and then we'll catch up.
This is weird. Why are these here? Okay.
And then you archive.
You can drag them, just a little double bars.
I don't know if they're doubles now or if for some reason they're at the bottom for no reason. Because Kaiju number 8 is supposed to be last. So, they're all out of order.
Start here. Okay. Go to here. Okay. And then we're going to
go back to the top,
and
I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
we'll do another intermission. I'll
try to figure
out
what's
happening right now.
So.
It's okay.
Euro camp till.
Irregular at high school.
Irregular, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm putting back the mics on. If you flip the mics are on back.
Okay.
And we're back.
Okay. Right. We are back. I think we've got this corrected for some of the videos that got skipped. We didn't realize that Crunchyroll trailers would be blocked in Japan. So they were just skipping over them. So we've added the Japanese versions here so that you guys don't miss out. So we're going to start with the mellow vibes I was talking about at the beginning of the show, Laid Back Camp season 3.
Okay.
This show makes me want a moped, like, really bad. Not nearly as useful in the United States as Japan.
Right.
Yeah.
This show is just vibes, just like beginning to end.
Yeah, I wish this was my kind of show.
Yeah.
But I'm not a slow life or slice of life person, really.
Okay.
Like, coming of age is a little different. Like, I'm there for coming of age, but just general slice of life. It's. I find it boring rather than relaxing.
See, it's like I used to be the same, and then there was like two shows that showed me, hey, slice of life can be good, or like that kind of like changed my mind.
Uh-huh.
Laid Back Camp was one of them actually, and I think especially watching a lot of slice of life after living in Japan for a while, which is sometimes you just want that dose of like nostalgia of like the kind of like environment and vibe that you felt. In some like rural places in Japan.
This series actually gave me like a new appreciation for at least the concept of camping.
Right.
Last time I went, it didn't quite meet like my expectations.
It might be the fact that I've spent like 130 days of my life camping and have really no need to do anymore.
Right.
I have no nostalgia for it. I mean, it's something I did that was fun, but
yeah.
No.
Well, I'm sure every campsite in Japan is happy because every time you go to a campsite, there's some Euro camp collaboration going on. Especially the curry. It's always the curry.
They did a lot for, I think it's Yamanishi Prefecture is
where this takes place.
Yeah. There was a lot of promotion, and then a bunch of people went out there and they had to issue like, hey, We need you guys to like be cool about it, though. Oh. All right. So this next one was also one that we weren't able to show earlier. So this is God's Game we play.
Okay.
Yes.
Yep.
Gods are hungry for games. Brain games. Okay.
Okay.
I think the gods would have, like, I don't know, an unfair advantage in that particular case.
That might be the whole point, you know. It's just like, and then humans came along and we took on the gods.
And I'm seeing hints of maybe a card game tie-in or something. Oh, this is one where everyone's got Pearl Diamond. Strange names.
Yes.
Mel Reckless.
Mel Reckless. What a name.
What a name. Yeah, this seems like a stealth card game promo, maybe.
Maybe like Records of Ragnarok mixed with No Game No Life is what I'm getting from this.
Yeah.
A bunch of humans take on some gods, but they don't fight. They just play Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yeah. I've tried a couple of the card game tie-in anime, but haven't really.
There's a couple that are like I've seen a lot of them, and I think the only one that really blew me away was Selector Infected Wii Cross.
Oh, okay.
Because that is like that is not at all what you were expecting.
Right.
I've heard that it gets really dark.
Oh yeah, it's super dark, super psychological.
Uh-huh. Right.
Like honestly, do you like Madoka Magica? You're gonna like Selector Infected Weakness.
Okay.
They're very similar in tone and vibe. Not necessarily in plot or anything, but like that kind of tone.
Uh-huh. Right.
And its sequels that are all kind of directly connected are all of the same level of quality, I'd say.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So this next one is about baseball. This is Oblivion Battery, and it's animated by MAPPA.
Is it a MAPPA original?
No, I'm pretty sure it's based on a manga.
Okay. Well, the thing about baseball anime is that there are so many baseball anime nowadays.
I think I was spoiled. My first baseball anime was H2, the Adachi manga.
Oh, okay.
So like Touch, H2, those are the things I started with, and it's kind of hard to compare.
Yeah, I mean, Ace of Diamonds was very, very good.
I did hear good things about that.
Yeah, that set the bar very, very high for me.
That boy has got a neck. Thick.
Oh my god.
But they were doing a really good job earlier with the pitching. Like there was an intensity to the pitch animation that I could appreciate there.
Oh my god, now that neck.
You can't unsee it. Boy doesn't skip upside the head and his friend doesn't remember him anymore.
Oh wait, skip neck day.
Boy doesn't skip neck day, man. That's why.
What?
It's not a mistranslation. That is what he said.
Okay. I feel like the necks just keep getting more intense. Yeah. I can't figure out if I like it or not.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so there definitely seems to be like a amnesia element going on with this.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, Ace of Diamonds put the baseball anime for me like the bar really high.
Yeah.
I also liked 1 Ounce as well, but that was like a Death Note and baseball anime put into one. I haven't really seen that many more baseball anime aside from that.
I mean, I know there's quite a few, but again, I haven't watched most. There's Major, there's
Giant
Killing.
Giant Killing's football.
Is it football?
A lot of them it's the same thing, right? Like they need to have some kind of twist at this point to really get my attention.
Yeah.
And who knows? Like, unfortunately, like that, I don't feel that the PV sold me the twist.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So I am interested to watch the first episode and see what it is.
Do you watch a lot of sports anime?
Well, I watch the first episode of every anime every season.
Yeah.
That's part of my job.
Preview guide. Yeah.
It's for the preview guide. But so yes, but do I continue watching them?
Yeah.
No, the vast majority I drop because it's just the same, you know, five pretty boy stereotypes playing a sport. It doesn't really matter what the sport is.
I enjoyed Haikyuu quite a lot.
Haikyuu's great.
Yeah.
Haikyuu is fantastic. I think that's my favorite modern sports anime.
Yeah.
Hajime no Ippo for like the kind of like going further back.
Yeah.
Ping pong.
I don't count that as a sports anime. That is a life anime. That's a life anime at this point, man.
Yeah, that one certainly stood out.
Yeah.
All I could think is like way in back, Princess Nine I enjoyed way back in the day.
Yeah.
A female baseball team trying to compete in the boys' high school league.
Yeah.
Which was a good.
Was that the one that was also like it took place during the Taisho era or something?
No. Okay. It was just a modern high school.
There's another one about a girls' team during, I think it's the Taisho era.
Okay.
I can't remember what it's called though off the top of my head. I'm sure chat will chime in.
And tell us.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah.
We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Yeah. I mean, the fact that they got MAPPA to animate it, like you don't do that for your run of the mill.
Yeah.
Story, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like that's a lot of money to spend before the show even starts. So.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Let's take a look at this next one. This was another one that we had to skip over earlier. Taisho Baseball Girls. Thank you.
Which one's this one, sir?
It was one of the ones we had to skip earlier.
Vanished former hero?
Vanished former hero lives as he pleases.
I think he has blue hair for once, not black hair, actually. Oh, and a twin-tailed, red-haired tsundere as well.
Princess, I bet. Yep. Let's see, this is guys a good-for-nothing, low-level, lack of a God-given gift. His name's Alan. I have an uncle named that. He's banished, but then he has a secret. He was a great hero in a previous life, yada, yada, yada.
Okay. I mean, I'll get that plot. Hero gets reincarnated, doesn't want to be a hero anymore.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Okay. Yeah, nothing really.
The one positive I will say about this trailer is I saw a dragon and it wasn't in CG.
Okay.
So
that is something. I don't really know that one warrants further comment.
Okay.
Thank you, Nicholas.
Yeah, we'll be sure to judge that book by its cover, right?
Yeah. Oh, that reminds me, how's our super chats? Guys, it's $3.
Okay.
$3 more.
It's a little chilly in here. I'm quite happy with
with
the jacket on.
All right. This next one looks cute. This is a pure romance series called A Condition Called Love, starring a 16-year-old high school first year. It's been ambivalent about love, but you know, it's gonna find her. That's how this works, right? Immediately getting, is he much older than her vibes?
Is this?
Nope, Never mind, they're in school together. He's just tall.
Okay, it's okay. Oh, is this an old school shoujo anime?
It kind of feels like normal girl gives
an umbrella to the pretty boy in class.
You know, he's a little bit edgy.
Yeah.
His ears are pierced, right?
He's a mysterious boy, misunderstood.
Yeah. Oh, is that a confession? Oh.
No, it's a, she doesn't understand, like, love.
Yeah.
She's ambivalent towards it, and she asks at the end, like, is it possible for me to love too?
That's
what she said at the end there.
17
bucks.
17 Yay! Bucks! Richard! Huh?
What? Plug the shirt.
Plug the shirt. All right. So this is a long neck, long sleeve, sheer bleach shirt from Otsuko. It's got a chain decal on it, which probably makes
sense. Cool.
It makes sense maybe if you know more about. Is that one of the attacks or something? Is that someone's special move? Okay. Okay. Well,
it's a turtleneck. That's all you need to know.
Yeah.
Baby.
Yeah. That was the surprise. That was the surprise out of the box.
Yeah.
It's turtleneck. Oh,
there you go.
I am flattered.
should we price for him to remove the hat or just?
Do you think people really? If people really want to see my bald head, they can watch the lights just flicker off.
And... It's turning slowly turning into strip poker now. It's just like.
Well, I mean, that's the last thing I think I can safely remove.
Yeah.
Socks?
Oh no!
No! We're not absolutely doing foot content.
No.
All right, no.
Richard, you're telling me you don't have a wiki feed?
No, I don't have a wiki feed. Although
no
I might
after
today. Jeez. Yeah. Gorg
doesn't have any clothing to remove without becoming shirtless or something, okay? Yeah, I mean, this is the After Dark set, but I don't think it's that After Dark, right?
Actually, we're filming this before dark.
Yeah, I'd like you guys to know it's like noon here, okay? This is lunchtime for the rest of us. All right. This next one, I think I've got high hopes for this. This is Windbreaker. So
yeah.
Despite the title and what it might make you think of, breaking wind.
Yes.
Or a particular.
Oh, I just thought about the jacket.
Yeah, the jacket.
I was like, what? Okay. Yeah.
Let's check out Windbreaker.
Yeah. I know more than one of the editorial staff is super excited for this one.
Yeah. The dude's got cool hair too. He's got like half
of his
hair,
right?
Like,
got
there we go.
Oh, delinquent anime.
Yeah. Okay. Heterochromia. I haven't seen that in a while.
Furin Koko, Sakura Haruka da.
Okay. Okay.
He was saying he wants it. It's like, you better remember my name. And then he says his name in his school.
Yeah. Like a delinquent fighting anime, I think, right?
Yeah.
Maybe this will like fill the void at that Tokyo Revengers.
Yeah. Well, it looks even cleaner than how Tokyo Revengers is animated.
Yeah. Oh, there's a dude with an eye patch.
Of course, okay. There's a dude with an eye patch.
Yeah.
This looks good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A delinquent animes are never really my thing.
Yeah.
I have too much real world experience.
Oh,
yeah. No, I was a teacher for a couple years and, I got assigned to the worst school in the prefecture.
Oh, wow.
I got to, you've never been a teacher until you've had to do firefighting in school because the students would light their desks on fire.
Oh my God.
Yeah, I went from a really good school to a bad school because what they did is they brought all the best teachers from all around and put them in the worst school to try to fix it.
Yeah.
And so I was just sitting there.
You were GTO.
I was part of like an ensemble GTO basically. Yeah, yeah, and they yeah. were one of the teachers I had worked with before was like, Richard, fire. And I'm like, okay. And both grab fire extinguishers and jog upstairs and put out the desks. Yeah, that was a day.
Yeah.
It did not just happen once, I'll tell you that too.
All right, production side is hinting at me that maybe we should do another super chat to make someone wear the Hunter cargo pants. Is that the signaling I'm getting right now?
They're not bad.
They're swishy pants.
They do look comfy.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah? How much will people pay to put Richard in the Hunter?
I'll wear those. those are wearable. I don't feel embarrassed at all to wear those. Those look good.
You want me to make Gart wear them?
Yeah, yeah. Here,
sure. Gart, you can wear them.
Sure.
Okay. These are Otsuko Hunter cargo green swishy pants. Great for are there zippers on those to turn them into shorts? Is that a zipper function?
I think shorts? That might be. Oh yes, it is.
Oh my god.
Oh. Okay. Fashionable.
Wow, they're versatile. Wow. Versatile.
Yeah.
All right, let's set the starting price for Gart to wear Hunter swishy pants at $25. $25.
Sure. So that's sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Five
sure.
super chats. Gart will wear the short or pants. Maybe if we get up to 50, we'll change it to shorts. How's that? Yeah. Get some knees on here. All
just
right.
Getting more skin showing. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah. I think we can do that. All right.
Fantastic.
All right. You guys have heard. All right. I'll let production let me know when we reach that goal there. All right. This next one is Tadaima Okairi. This is a BL show about two men raising a child together.
Oh.
Yeah. So this is wholesome, unlike the pants that we're discussing. But this is wholesome. Yeah. Cute baby.
Oh. But does it have a space oomphy?
Does it have a space oomphy? No.
God damn, this is adorable.
It's too cute. That's how I felt watching that. So yeah, that's it's Masaaki Fujiyoshi is a stay-at-home husband. He has no self-confidence, and his husband Hiromu is an elite salaryman, and they have a 2-year-old son named Hikari, and together they overcome life's joys and sadness and become more of a family every day. So that's just,
I mean, what more is there to say about that? It looks like you know exactly what you're getting into with that show. That looks adorable.
Yeah, it looked really cute. I love the way anime babies always have that same like really squishy face.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, they are married.
Yeah.
It's not implied or, you know, like wink, that's wink, nice. Nudge, nudge.
Yeah.
It's, yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah. All right. So this next one is a Remonster, and it is a reincarnated as a goblin. Is I think the main crux of this one.
The anti-goblin slayer.
Anti-goblin slayer.
That's interesting. Because I've actually seen this done in Reincarnated as a Spider.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay.
Is the same thing, but one of the characters is reincarnated as a goblin.
Oh, yes. Okay.
The anime hasn't reached that point yet, but it is, well, it kind of has, depending on flashbacks, flash forwards, all that
right,
kind of stuff.
Right.
But
a lot of goblin ladies.
Yes.
But also a lot of goblin abs. So, you know.
Just goblins everywhere.
Everywhere goblins.
Oh. It looks like he upgrades to an ogre.
Yeah.
He evolves into an ogre.
No giant witch hats yet. His armor is kind of cool looking.
Yeah. I mean, I'd be curious to see how far they lean into the whole goblin aspect of things.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering how much we can do with the concept of just, you know, being in the ring, being reincarnated as a goblin.
Yeah.
Because like if he goes to orc so quickly.
Yeah. Right.
Like, because you can assume that a trailer is coming from footage from like the first two or three episodes, right, unless it's right. like a Netflix thing where they've done them all, right?
Yeah.
So I'm kind of wary about that because it just means like that you bypass your own premise very quickly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like one thing if it was like super weak goblin survival kind of story.
Yeah.
You know, regardless of how lighthearted you want to make it. But when you you know, immediately it's like, oh, also now super strong ogre. Oh, yeah. Well,
where do we go from here? Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
that seems like the end point, not the like
yeah. early I'd be curious point. To see what they do after the first few episodes, I think. Yeah. That's gonna be the real tell.
Yeah. That one seemed about like middle of the road
yeah.
for me.
It's certainly watchable.
Yeah.
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 I probably like just from the trailer, I'd probably do give it the 3-episode watch.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm actually impressed so far with all the trailers. There hasn't been anything that stood out where I was just like, no thank you, looks like garbage.
Yeah,
the only things that the closest it's like there's a couple that I'm like, okay, I know that's not for me.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that I think it's going to be like atrocious or bad.
Yeah.
Know what my tastes are.
The spring looks like it's running out to be pretty stacked
so far already.
All right, so I think this next one is the third season of the Irregular at Magic High School.
Yep.
What?
This got kind of controversial.
This is coming back?
Yeah, it is.
This is coming back?
Yeah.
It always does well.
Yeah.
I mean, I've seen it and reviewed it all for the site. So, yeah, it's, I mean, it's this ongoing thing. And I'll certainly say the second season was very much like had a subplot that was to set up this season.
Oh, right.
Okay. Like a lot more bringing in the rest of his family. Okay. The whole point is that the brother and sister in this very cutthroat family that's one of the big like magical families of Japan, and like it's all about who's going to be the successor, and the sister is considered like the front runner, and of course that means that interfamily war is always on the horizon.
Okay, let's see where season 3 is heading. It's 10th anniversary for this franchise.
It was just like yesterday, the first season came out, and
isn't the sister kind of like more into her brother than
I
like how you like admitted that and you like your synopsis. I was like, when are you gonna mention that? When
trust me, that's about to become, I think if this is the TV I've seen of this, then that's about to become very clear.
Is it one of the things where he's like kind of obtuse about it? Like,
it's not that he's obtuse, it's actually the exact opposite.
Yeah.
The idea within, I don't know, do I spoil the first season?
I guess so. We're on season 3 right now.
Yeah.
Something is wiggling.
We have destroyed it.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was like in shake mode.
Yeah. Is it the stream?
That's an interesting thing peeking out there.
Yeah.
I think it probably has something to do with the full screen.
Weird. That was
new glitches.
Is it?
Oh,
it's okay. It's back now. But basically, I guess I can talk about Irregular. Waiting. But like, it's basically the idea is he was conditioned like as a child, like basically tortured magically to the point that he would only feel any kind of emotion towards his sister. Like that's the only person like he can feel any feelings for.
Okay.
And it was so that he's basically her slave.
Yeah.
Like, she can say anything, do anything, and he will do it. It's absolutely treated as a horrible thing that happened to him.
Yeah.
That's basically the thing. And then
does she know that?
Oh yes, she's fully 100% aware. Yeah. And like to her, it's like, oh, her brother has given up literally everything for her.
Yeah.
Like his life has been taken away for her sake. And
I'm just like, I remember the Irregular. I can't remember the full name, Mahoka. One of the big like. I remember the anime went through a phase where instead of isekai, we had like the magic harem high school kind of shows. Yeah. And that was one of the biggest, and I think what made it stand out, why people were talking about it, was because of the relationship with the brother and the sister.
Yeah.
that was the big talking point,
right,
that everyone always talked about.
Yeah. It's an interesting thing, because she's at least a good enough person to just know how horrible it is and refuse to exploit it.
Okay.
Because of her own like she gets it, she understands the whole thing.
Yeah.
And so it's very much central is their bond.
I'm just surprised they're bringing it back, because it's been 8 years since the previous one, and I wouldn't exactly call this, I don't know.
No, season two couldn't have been that long ago.
Season two was it's like the 10-year anniversary.
Yeah, it was a 10-year anniversary,
because they did the first season and then we had the movie which came after, which was interesting because it skipped way ahead in the story.
Yeah.
And then we got the spinoff of season one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The Honor at Magic High School. Yeah.
And it all kind of came together.
Okay. Mahoka season two. How long has it been?
It had to be 4 years, 3 years or 4 years.
Yeah.
Just because I reviewed it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I reviewed for A&M.
Oh, okay.
But.
Oh, you're right. It's 2020. Wow.
Yeah. I think that I wouldn't be surprised if it was just because the movie actually did well.
Right.
Because there was a film. That's
because the movie really skipped. It was interesting because it skipped several arcs ahead. Mm-hmm. So it was clearly for a light novel audience.
Right.
And then it's not until near the end of season two where all the characters that show up in the movie are actually introduced.
Oh, okay. That's weird.
Yeah.
So did the movie come out before season two?
It was season one, and then there's this dead zone, and then suddenly we got the movie.
Right.
And then it was I guess we can.
I guess people still want to see Mahoka. Yeah.
Yeah. What was it? Way back in the day when I first watched it, I remember someone was describing it as magical atomic Batman. That's how they referred to the series.
That makes it sound way cooler than it actually is.
Yeah, it does.
Magical Atomic Batman. No, but it's insane to think that the first Mahoka came out 10 years ago.
I remember it
blowing up in the whole the Sword Art Online era.
Well, I mean, we get the same theme song singer.
Yeah.
We have the sibling romance.
Sibling romance thing. OP main character.
There's a fighting game called Dengeki Bunko Fighting Climax.
Oh, yes.
Which Dengeki Bunko is the publisher for both Sword Art Online and Mahoka.
Yeah.
So the characters cross over. And yes, in the stories, there are scenes where Miyuki talks with Lifa from Sword Art Online, and they talk about brother love. With the Seiyu.
Did they do Orimo as well?
Yes. And there is a scene. Well, and I believe the sister from Orimo is also is Lisa, Leafa's voice actress. So she talks to herself about it.
Wow.
Because when you get typecast, you get typecast.
This is a weird crossover of the Avengers.
Super chat set? $5 super chat for the pants.
The pants while we work on technical stuff.
Yeah, we work on technical stuff.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Darken and Black. I have not heard that name in a very, very long time.
Oh, yeah. No, that was his description of Magical High School.
Yeah.
It was Darker Than Black.
Is it the streaming software, Nabi? Okay.
It's at the very bottom, the one that we were on.
What is the stream seeing right now? Are they seeing what we're seeing, or?
Because I hope they're not seeing what we're
seeing. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, okay.
So stream, the camera, the TV is kind of glitching out right now.
Yeah.
And we're just working through some technical issues. Don't worry, we're not going anywhere.
Yeah. Oh, we could talk about the one we skipped.
Yeah, there's also one on here that we do have to skip because of for copyright issues. And so that's an archdemon's dilemma, how to love your elf bride.
Yep.
Okay.
Which, yeah, another one I've actually read.
Okay, yeah. I know that the Japanese title is actually slave, maybe not bride, but
it is. Yeah. It's like, I have an elf. What is it? Like, I have an elf.
Slave, how do I love her? Yeah, yeah.
Is it like Chain Soldier, where they had to change like the localization translation?
Kind of like, it's what was it? The Ancient Magus's Bride kind of thing.
Yeah, okay.
Wizard buys special girl.
Yeah,
kind of.
And then they fall for each other. Okay.
But it's absolutely like. Like if we're talking levels of quality, it's not nice to compare those two.
Oh,
right.
$20. Oh my
god! All right.
Show us the pants.
All right.
Show us the pants.
Oh.
Yeah. Garmel will be putting these on off camera because we're not that kind of show.
But yeah. So yeah, I mean it's kind of interesting. Like it's not terrible like you'd think. Mm-hmm. It's not a it's not etchy focus.
Oh, okay.
It's like
this is the elf bride one.
Yeah, the elf bride one. Yeah. Like the most of the wizards are pretty much all magic users are pretty much generally evil.
Okay.
And all trying, you know, to climb the ranks kind of thing. And yeah, it's just kind of how they interact in their lives and how he starts to care about her, which is something that, you know, these evil magicians aren't supposed to do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Garn is back with the pants. Oh,
he's got the pants.
He's
got them.
How do those feel, Garn? They feel good?
You feel good. Nice and airy.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Good breathability.
Yeah. It's actually way more comfortable than the jeans I was wearing. Nice.
Yeah. Those swishy pants
there. Yeah, well, it looks like I'm just repping Togashi today because I got Yu Hakusho on top and Hunter on the bottom. Yeah.
It's got the logo there on one of the legs too.
Ooh,
one, which is kind of cool.
Oh, that's cool.
The whole font out there.
Yeah. Hunter. Yeah, logo's on there several times. That's nice. So yeah, 25 more and they become shorts.
Yep, 25 more and you can see Garn's calves. So
please, it ain't summer yet, boy.
Actually, the weather was kind of nice out today, though.
All right. Do we? Okay.
Looks like we might need a
reset
here, huh?
Yeah, do we need to?
We're going to reset the stream, and then we'll be right back. This should probably fix the trailer the streaming issue we're having.
Yeah, we're hoping.
It doesn't look like the screen is seizing.
Yeah,
we don't want to be responsible for...
Yes.
For a flashing eye Pikachu.
Yes.
Yes.
Mark II.
So we will be right back. Are the mics muted? Yeah, close the window. Okay.
Yeah.
And we were down at a regular magical high school.
Yeah.
And that's the last one before we go back up to Girls Band Cry is the one after that.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's okay.
Yeah.
We just have to restart it.
Okay.
Oh, we're back.
Yeah. Okay. Woo!
Okay. All right.
All right.
We've got it fixed. We think. Moment of truth.
And we got a drum roll going.
All right.
All right. So back to the show about the guy who's been PTSD'd into obeying his sister who's in love with him.
I'm sorry, this is the show we had to stop on. Yeah. we could have stopped on, you know, the Kyoto animation show or something.
Yeah.
Alright.
Here we go. From the top. Alright, there's Tatsuki. And all of his friends.
Yeah, all of his friends. And it's like part of the story is that he does slowly but surely get feelings back for these people around him.
Yeah.
And does become the true friend.
Okay.
But it's a slow process. It's kind of the point of the show.
Yeah. It looks like Asa over there for a second.
I mean, it really does look like the composition has, like, it looks a lot cleaner.
Yeah. It certainly has evolved with the times.
Yeah.
In a good way.
Yeah.
What's that? That looked like a zombie, like, attacked to a bunch of wiring or something.
But yeah, this whole thing makes it look like someone is trying to usurp the bond that he has with
her
and basically turn him into her slave instead of
Yuki's. Lisa doing the song though.
Yeah, like, well, she did it for the other ones too.
Oh, did she?
Yeah, this was the Sword Art Online
era,
right?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
you wanted to get your Sword Art Online peeps on board, you had to have a Lisa theme song.
Yeah, yeah.
Good to see Lisa stayed on. Oh, there we go.
Yep. There it is. Mahouka Koukou no Rettousei, Dai San Season, 2024, 4月, Kaishi. Do you know if the light novels are still running for this too, or is it?
Yes. Well, yes and no. Like, it went on to. I believe it's past where they graduate at this point.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
I think it's about, like, I think he might start a company or something after graduation.
Oh, okay.
I haven't read any of them, but it does. Okay. So is it over? Yes and no.
Yeah.
You know.
And how many seasons do they need?
Yeah. Yeah. But it could. How long could it go?
Yeah.
Long.
Yeah.
Long.
Never underestimate light novel sales, especially when it comes to this kind of genre.
Yeah.
Nabi, I don't know why, but the next one, Astronaut, the video for that is at the very bottom. I don't know how it got there, but up and up. Nope, down. Yes. Astronaut.
Did we miss the many sides of voice actor radio?
Yeah. We did Girls Band Cry already.
Mm-hmm.
Many Sides of Voice Actor Radio. I'm going to have to find that trailer for us because it was a Crunchyroll one. And then the next one is Astronaut, which is the third one from the bottom there. And I think this is an original series. The character designs are by Eisaku. I can't remember his last name. He also did a bunch of character designs for those Bump of Chicken Cup Noodle One Piece.
Oh, okay.
It's got a very distinctive art style. So
okay.
When you see it, it'll be recognizable. Yeah.
A lot of anime originals this season.
Yeah.
Oh, I recognize the. Yeah. This. The slice of life, One Piece.
I want to make breakfast for you.
Oh, is that what he said?
Yes. Or let me make breakfast.
Yeah, the main character talking is a talented chef, but he was just fired, and so he starts working at an old boarding house.
And the girl's an alien, right?
Sure looks like it.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is an alien.
And there's a talking dog. Of course.
Something tells me she may not be the only alien.
Yeah.
She's probably the least looking alien out of the bunch here.
Can the poodle talk?
It seems that this voice we're hearing is the poodle, I think.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the trope I'll never fully understand. Yeah. But why is the Japanese image of an alien like an octopus?
I'm sure there's really some origin to that.
I don't know what it is.
I mean, octopuses definitely look alien, you know.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, I mean, the character designs are charming, but I don't know, it's just some sort of like an off-the-wall comedy. I'm real picky about comedies.
Same here, especially like with comedy anime. Yeah. There are so many comedy anime where I'm like, I laugh in my head, but I don't like laugh out loud. It was just kind of like, that was mildly that was amusing, cute, you know, that was cute. Yeah, so comedy anime is very hard to find good ones. Right.
Yeah, I mean, I think comedy tastes can also vary a lot.
I mean, it's the hardest one. Like, it's hard to ever say something bad about a comedy because it just means it's not for you, right?
Yeah.
There is somebody out there who's just laughing nonstop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even if it's not you.
All right. This next one is called Blue Archive. This is based on a mobile game from Nexon. Yes.
This thing, like, so every couple of years, you can play it. You don't have to wait for me to talk.
Yeah.
But like every couple of years, we get the new otaku obsession mobile game thing.
Yes.
So we had, you know, FGO was it for a while.
Yeah.
Arknights. What was the one? It recently had actually kind of a popular game in the West.
Genshin?
Grand Blue.
Oh, Grand Blue. Yeah.
Yeah, Grand Blue. Things like that. And the most recent one is
Blue Archive. I've seen Blue. Yeah.
It's the one that's blowing up all over.
Yeah.
Okay. Because I hadn't heard anything about it before the anime was announced. And all I could tell from the pictures was like the girls have halos and also animal ear hair, but they have the double ears like we were talking about earlier. And I don't know, submachine guns or something.
Yeah, I know nothing about it either. But I know of Blue Archive, and that's simply because you can tell like the FGO thing. There's certain series that you see fan art of like a lot that appear on the timeline.
Exactly.
And Blue Archive has a lot of fan art that
it's become the new big one.
Yeah. That all the illustrators like to draw you know, fan art of.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I think they just also revealed the character design for the sensei character as well. Maybe that's the player character in the game, I'm assuming.
Okay.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I really don't know much about it.
Okay.
In general.
Oh, sorry? Really? The sensei being male. People were happy about that?
So we just got told by a producer that everyone was ecstatic that the sensei is a male.
Yeah.
So the player character's male.
Okay.
So they can fully immerse in the gacha game experience. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Right.
All right. This next one is called Unnamed Memory, and it looks like another fantasy series. There's supposed to be a witch in it. So again, maybe the big hat count. Waiting for the big hat. Show me the big hat. It is a very run-of-the-mill looking main character, but you know, Does he also work in an office? Like,
oh, is it going to be one of these shows where it's, you know, the dynamic between one snarky girl and one,
like accommodating, pleasant type?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Now we're going.
Okay.
Okay, but something dark is happening.
Ooh.
Yeah, why is he wearing a business suit? I'm kind of hung up on it, I guess. Is there a cult?
Okay, okay.
So we have a knight and a magic user.
Yes.
Like a, like, magic bow and arrow. That was kind of neat. I'm mostly sold on the villain because he seems to be batshit. So. But overall, I don't know. This trailer is just kind of not doing it.
Is this, yeah, is this an original?
I don't. I'm gonna guess this is a light novel. I definitely got light novel vibes from that.
Yeah. Yeah.
You can know, you can normally tell when the duo have this kind of like dynamic,
yeah,
together.
Yeah. Looks like light novel and manga based on,
yeah, that, yeah.
That little bit that we had there. But yeah, when I read the synopsis for this one, I thought it sounded interesting, but the actual trailer is now giving me pause.
Yeah, I'm curious to see what the dynamic is gonna be between the main duo. I think, yeah, that's gonna be what really sells this one.
Yeah.
Especially if it's one of those kind of like Rascal Doesn't Dream of Bunny Girl Senpai, where the duo have good dynamic enough that it like carries,
yeah,
through,
carry the whole series.
Carry the whole, yeah, series. Yeah. I wasn't sure about the rest of the premise aside from that.
Yeah. Well, before we move on to the next one, we have another quick word from our sponsor. This is from iBuyPower. They provided this PC case you see here with Mori Calliope on the front of it. So, let's take a look at the ad and learn more about it.
Hey everyone, hope you all are enjoying the Anime News Network Trailer Watch Party. I have to give a big shout out to iBuyPower really fast because look at these beautiful PC cases. Kawaii, am I wrong? We gotta give a big thank you to iBuyPower and their family brand Height, a PC peripheral company that's pioneered the modern desktop aesthetic. And also, shout out to Hololive. Height is proud to be in partnership with Hololive English for this officially licensed Heiko's Bells and Mori Calliope case. Now, y'all know Mori Calliope, the popular Grim Reaper rapper. Well, their PC case comes with a gift box, including Ricky enamel side keychain and Death Sensei charm, Mori Calliope Chibi Edition acrylic keychain, enamel microphone stand pin, exclusive Mori Calliope sticker sheet, and this limited edition Mori Calliope wall scroll. Absolutely loving this. And also, really quickly, take a look again at this one, because the dice theme for the PC is based off of Play Dice, Bale's Casino theme song.
Yeah,
so I don't know about y'all, but the colors, the aesthetics, these are absolute perfection in my opinion. But leave a comment and tell us what you think of these PCs, and we got something for you. That's right. Use this code and you get 5% off of anything Height collection. Woohoo! All right, see you later.
All right, thanks, Jackie. again, this is an example of the iBuyPower PC case. It's look got a lot look, of nice art on it.
Look how clean that looks, guys. Yeah. Of course.
Looks better than my PC case. I'll tell you that much.
Of course, if you didn't know, yeah, Mori Calliope, friend of the show. She's been on before on Trash Taste right there. So get your PC today because this looks awesome.
Yeah. And thank you again to iBuyPower for making the Trailer Watch Party possible. So let's move on to our next trailer. This one is going to stream on Hulu, which
Hulu.
Hopefully that doesn't mean it gets stuck in kind of the Hulu black hole zone.
Right.
Mm. don't tell Hulu I said that, I guess, but they do have some really great anime that have been on there exclusively, like Heavenly Delusions was a Hulu series.
Oh, in America?
Yeah, it was.
Oh, it was Disney Plus here.
We get lucky. Yeah. All the Hulu stuff over here becomes Disney Plus.
Oh, I guess I should add that they are starting to move it over to Disney Plus in America as well. It was Hulu only for a while, and now I've started to see it transfer over. Like, I watched One Punch Man on Disney Plus like a little while back.
Wow.
It's kind of weird still with the branding of it.
Yeah.
So this next one, it's Mission Yozakura Family. They had a pretty cool booth too over at Anime Japan. If you go to Anime News Network's social media, you can see me fail miserably at trying to do target shooting with a pop gun.
As well as your ring toss and fishing escapades.
Hey, I succeeded at fishing.
You did.
Only. Yeah.
But then again, the gun thing, I don't blame that on you. The way that the targets basically have a huge base at the bottom, so you actually have to hit them at the very tip top to knock them over, not dead center, you know, where the crosshair is and the bullseye is. Yeah. So some carny tricks going on there.
There were definitely, And I didn't quite understand the Hulu toss, so I did a couple frisbee throws, which was apparently wrong, and I was just supposed to kind of, Anyway, if that shows up elsewhere, there's some tips so you can win the free swag after my failure. Yeah. But this is Mission Yozakura Family.
So from this, like, what I learned from our preview guide. From our most anticipated.
Yeah.
Yes, this is a spoiler because I don't know if it's been published yet.
Oh.
But this is apparently similar in overall plot to like Spy Family kind of thing.
Oh, okay.
So you have a family of spies doing secret-y things.
Okay.
Well, starting things off heavy because we just find out he just like lost orphans, his entire family.
Yeah. Welcome to our spy family. All right.
So the guy with a bucket on his head. Bucket man over there. What?
What is that? Like, is it supposed to be Faust from Guilty Gear?
Yeah.
Not a bucket instead of a paper bag.
Well, this looks like a very weird family.
Yeah.
It's almost like Assassination Classroom with how unhinged it is.
Yeah, it actually feels more like that.
That kind of like tone and vibe, right?
I like the... I like a lot of the character designs coming out of this. The guy in the black suit that showed up with
it looks like it's
wires.
A mid-level animation, but they're like doing the most they possibly can with it.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
It seems like they have a lot of, like you said, unique characters as well. Like the guy with the bucket on his head. What is he assassinating?
And the real curls for life.
Yeah.
They also like showed a point where like his forearm just like
suddenly became buff.
Super buff, which is kind of off-putting and weird, but in a good way. Yeah.
It looks like your unhinged comedy action show. Down for that.
Yeah, so keep an eye out for that one. Again, that's going to be over on Disney Plus or Hulu. So, you know, easy to slip through the cracks if you're not used to going to those streaming services to watch it. But I think it looks pretty good. So, all right. This next one is called Kurasuwa Aruji no Erebanai. And it also kind of centers around yokai, specifically Yatagarasu, which are like crow people. But it seems like it's kind of like a historical court drama. But instead of it being like a typical like shogun sort of thing, it's
the opening theme, if I'm reading that correctly, is done by Saucy Dog. What a name!
The opening thing. So yeah, let's see. Take a look at this one. This is based on a series of novels.
Okay.
Okay. Everyone's pretty. Okay. So the first thing sticking out to me is we haven't seen a lot of animation yet, which can kind of...
The backgrounds look very pretty, though.
Yes.
Like the background art. Oh, it's like a
Yeah, Imperial Court.
Yeah, Imperial drama. Court, yeah. Kind of like drama. That's...
Yeah. Okay, this dude's just turning straight up into crows.
Okay.
You know, because it is a court drama too, maybe it can get by on like good script writing and dialogue.
You know? Yeah, you don't need a lot of action and fighting necessarily. Yeah. Although it's trying to show us there is some.
Yeah. Normally, like the Imperial Palace dramas, are not really my thing. I think the only one I've gotten into recently is Apothecary Diaries.
Okay,
so that's just
I've heard really good things.
That's just on like another level.
I would also recommend Raven of the Imperial Palace.
Yeah,
that one. Yeah, it was same kind of thing though, mystery solving.
Yeah,
kind of thing, but like had this like supernatural bent.
Right.
It.
Yeah,
it was interesting.
Yeah, because I think. It was the writing of Apothecary Diaries that really drew me to it. I thought Mao Mao was just such an interesting character. So I might, I don't know, that trailer didn't really sell me on this one.
Right.
Yeah.
I think I'll probably watch the first episode to kind of get a better grasp on the vibe of it and stuff. But yeah, it did seem kind of like could be, could not be added to my watch list. Not entirely sold on that.
Yeah.
With production, how's our super chats going? Same. All right. Well, if everyone's just satisfied with Garnt wearing pants, we'll just let Garnt wear
pants. I'm happy. This is comfy. Yeah.
All right. This next one is called The Fable. And I think it's a retired Yakuza sort of story.
Yeah.
You know, he did some hits and now he has to lay low for a year as a normal person.
Okay.
But this is a guy born and raised to be a hitman. He's never been anything but a hitman.
Okay.
Yeah.
Him trying to live normally is
hard.
Amazing.
I've heard so much good things about the manga.
The Fable is amazing.
Yeah.
It's a really good manga.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's check out the trailer for the anime then. If I remember right, this is also a Disney Plus.
Is this
Hulu title, which which is kind of funny.
この6年で71人やってる。特に今年は多かった。で、次はいつ頃?いや、しばらくは仕事は取らん。今年はやりすぎた。
Yeah, so they did too much killing, so I have to take a break for a year.
Okay.
And like he is like the killer among killers. No one's even close. And he happens to like the only thing that makes him laugh is this one really bad comedian.
Okay.
It's the same punchline for every joke and he just laughs at it. And then his friend is this girl who her thing is she loves to get men drunk and turn them into drunken messes and then just basically tease them while they're super drunk. And it's kind of like she's his handler.
Okay.
And they're kind of both exiled to this, you know,
so it's
out of the way place.
Sitcom John Wick, John Wick
comedian.
Yeah, it is a comedy, but you know, it's like he's also the most badass killer ever to be born.
Yeah,
okay.
But it's a lot of jokes about Japanese society and working life, where he gets like he gets the bottom of the barrel, like part time job where he's basically a wage slave, and he's like, oh, this is great, I have money. because he has no idea what normal is.
Well, the animation was a little lackluster in that regard.
Yeah, I'm a little worried about that. It's not exactly super heavy on the action.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. There are like really key action bits to it.
Yeah.
Okay. So I do kind of wonder about that. And if you're interested though in like the story, if I pitched it well.
Yeah.
There have been two live action adaptations here in Japan.
It does seem like something that really would lend itself to live action really well.
It is really funny. Like they do a good job with the live action.
Because one thing that does worry me is I think this is done by the same studio that did Under Ninja two seasons ago.
Yeah.
And that was more of like I really like the vibe of this, but I think this is like a read the manga kind of deal where I'm worried that The Fable is going to be the same way as well, because I've heard so many good things about the manga, and from the trailers that we've seen, I don't know if that's going to live up to what the manga has done. But
that was the feeling that I was getting as well.
Yeah.
All right. This next one is somehow we're on like the fifth season of Data Live.
Five seasons, several movies. Sure, why not?
Yeah.
I'm sure we had some OVAs in there somehow.
Yeah, I'm sure.
What's this show about? Like a guy and his super girlfriends, right? Basically,
I think
the world end once.
If I remember, like I don't know very much about this one, but if I remember correctly, the plot hook is basically the superpower girls will explode and destroy the world if he can't, but so he, unless they fall in love with him.
Oh, sure. Okay. Right.
Like that's literally the plot. Yeah. But it is as trite as that sounds. Uh-huh. Like you can, I don't know if you guys can hear the background staff laughing at that.
The production team thought that was very funny.
Fans of the show really do like seriously think it's a good show. Like not a pandering show. Like they're not like this panders to me. It's my trash. They're like, no, this is a really good show. Uh-huh.
So the British in me heard that as like a sarcastic statement. They're like, they actually think this is a good show.
And that's the thing though, like there's probably something to it that I don't know.
Yeah.
Like the amount of people that have really like,
oh no, it has a dedicated fan base.
Right. Like it's not the kind of dedicated fan base I think you would get from if it was all pretty girls trope, you know, pretty girls fan service.
Right.
So
this is
one that I hesitate to make fun of because like,
oh no, the fan base will come for your throats.
And it seems like there is something there.
Yeah.
But five seasons is
we
a
don't
lot.
Know. Yeah. But it does. Right.
I mean,
like...
five seasons speaks for itself.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm not too familiar with the franchise. More the fandom and the fan base that has come around the franchise itself.
Think, like one of the main girlfriends is kind of got that goth Lolita aesthetic that was popular in the mid-aughts. So some of it kind of just seems like out of time at this point. Like it's just a relic that just keeps going but hasn't really updated.
Right.
I don't know. You guys can come for me at @ANN_ Lynzee on Twitter. I can take it. I can take
we can
it.
Watch this.
Yeah, let's have a look.
Yeah.
They've made an army.
The girlfriends are fighting in mechas.
Yeah,
mech suits.
It's kind of like a mech musume kind of deal.
Sorry, I was just reading that. I was like, oh my god, that's proper noun word salad right there. It's just 50 proper nouns that I have no idea what they mean. Oh no.
Paper airplanes?
I've heard that it is created with their like powers.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does some superpower creativity. But
how did the man make that old guy even look kind of like cute? That was Oh yeah, I forgot he got the heterochromia.
Yeah,
gotta get that. Gotta have the heterochromia.
We can rebuild it. We can make it stronger.
Yeah, I mean, it's weird to think that it's still ongoing. This is like the fifth season. I kind of
never would have expected that.
See this as like a time capsule almost of just the aesthetic of like late 2000s, you know, early 2010s anime.
Yeah.
And it's still ongoing. It's that's all I can really say about it because I do not know too much about Data Live. But the fan base just won't let it die.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Way to come out for your face.
Oh, and I want to be clear. Like, we might be poking a little fun here and there.
Yeah.
But it's not wrong for you to like what you like.
Yeah. No. It's like it's fine.
Because we all have actually, our things that we like.
Yes.
That we you know that we wouldn't want to be judged for. So just take that as our true feelings underneath the fun we're having.
Yes. Exactly. Nabil, for some reason, again, the next one is at the bottom of the list.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
That is the one.
Oh, I'm so excited for this one.
So, yeah, this is a remake.
This is a remake. Yes.
Bartender was, like, it kind of went under the radar. The first season wasn't available in English for a long time.
Exactly.
And then they got a home video release. But it's just sort of this cool like human drama about the customers that come in, and he serves them the perfect drink and helps them with their problems. And now it's kind of getting this revitalization with Bartender Glass of God. So this is the new season.
Yep.
See, and it doesn't sound so darn pretentious in Japanese, you know?
It doesn't, yeah.
Glass of God?
Yeah, well, yeah, just Kamino Grasa.
Yeah, Kamino Grasa.
And that doesn't sound near as pretentious.
This is the glass of God that you are getting. I love this show. And it's just got such a simple concept as well.
When did the original come out? I have no memories of this.
Mid-2000s, I remember. Yeah.
2006. Okay, that explains it.
Yeah.
There was a literally from the day I arrived in Japan for the next 5 years, I didn't watch any anime.
Right, right.
I was like, I'm here for real.
What did you like about it, Garth?
I mean, it was just like, one, it was like the comfy vibes, and two, it was just the concept of, so the whole concept of this is that you have people who are going through different things in life, different problems. They go to this one bar, and the bartender, depending on their story, will make like the perfect cocktail for whatever situation they're going through that will like comfort them. And I don't know, it was just such a wholesome, comfy vibe. And especially now that I've lived in Japan for a while, I've been to like bars like this. You go in, there's no menu, you order what you want, and it's just one guy in this small dinky bar that just runs it, like shaves all the ice for you right in front of you, makes the drink, and just has a nice chat with you. And sometimes you just need that. It's just like nice company, nice conversation. That's it.
Yeah, it's a good setup for like little short slice of life stories. Episodic slice of life.
Yeah, there's like a few shows like this where some of them are anime, some of them are live action. Midnight Dino is a show that, is one that me and my wife like to watch, where, you know, you go to a diner, it's like dead of night, and they serve you nice food, and they just listen to the customer's story and whatever they go through. I have to say, it's the same vibe as this. I have a real soft spot for this kind of anime and this kind of show.
Looks nice, yeah.
Yeah, I kind of just emulates the vibe of just going to a real life bar and just hearing some interesting stories about what people are going through. You meet all types of people.
Yeah, I've watched a couple of anime that have like similar, just one episode per drama. None are coming to mind right now, but yeah, those can be.
Well, I mean, like even like Death Parade uses that.
Yes.
Right. Death Parade's a pretty, in a very different way, similar thing. More on the darker nature, but
And that has like an ongoing storyline. But
and I did like that in the background.
Yeah,
I do like when you do an episodic story, but there isn't an overarching plot in the background that eventually becomes gives you a climax at the end.
Exactly.
It draws everything together. I like that style of storytelling.
I agree.
Oh, really? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. That was on the money then.
Yeah. You're on the money. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. This next one is called The New Gate. No relation to Gate.
Oh, no.
Which
was
something completely different.
Oh, that's an isekai.
I'm so excited for this show. I shouldn't be. It's one of my most anticipated. But
The New Gate is?
Oh, yes.
Oh, okay. Let's.
You will probably pick up why as we watch the trailer.
Is there a villainess in it, Richard?
No.
It's a video game? Video game?
Yeah, it does have like an NMO slant.
How about I just tell you the setup while we're watching?
Okay.
Since we have no subtitles.
Okay.
This is Sword Art Online.
I was going to
say
that.
What happens at the end of Sword Art Online when Kirito frees them from the death game?
Yeah.
What if then he wakes up 1,000 years later in the game world, which has now become a real living, breathing world? There are characters who are like his NPC elf friend or whatever, who remembers being a game character.
Even
though it's 1,000 years later. And so it's this interesting thing about why, when he beat the death game, was he reincarnated in the future? Why what impact did he and the players have on this fantasy world?
Right.
And it's basically him dealing with all the implications of his actions in freeing the death game.
Huh. Okay.
Well, you've just sold me 10 times more than that trailer did,
yeah. Right? Yeah, it's not a very good trailer.
Because I looked at that and I'm like, oh, who is this curator looking ass? All right. Yeah,
and that's really what it is. Like, it's literally like our legally distinct kitty doll. Yeah. Name is Sheen. And that's it. Like, and it was very interesting. Like, is during a long period of time, I didn't really read manga, even when I was watching anime.
Right.
And somehow, randomly, I stumbled upon The New Gate. And I was just like, oh, yeah, this is 100% for me.
Yeah.
I like my Sword Art Online. And so, yeah, it's a very interesting twist on Sword Art Online. Like, it, you know, yeah. We have twists on villainous stories. We have twists on every isekai idea possible.
Yeah.
And this one is just like, yes, we're gonna twist Sword Art Online. Like, that's it.
Okay.
And it's
that sounds honestly really interesting. Ride. Yeah. I mean
it's not gonna be winning awards. I don't think it's gonna be on any best of season lists.
Yeah. But
if you like Sword Art Online, you will like this. You will enjoy it.
All right. Well, I'm watching that.
I think this is a good place to take a second quick intermission to update the trailer list real quick, because we're coming up on quite a few missing ones that I want to make sure we get in here. So
okay.
All right. We'll be right back.
Okay. Did we? I thought we only missed one or two here.
Yeah, but the ones about to come up aren't right. Like
We're about to hit them.
Or Vampire Dorm or Black Butler. This is, I think, the Grandma Grandpa. So like, we're missing like five.
Okay. And then the one we did miss was the mini sides of the voice actor radio. That's the only other one that you need to add. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's fine either way.
Yeah, I'm good. Oh, wow.
Like live right now, we've got typical 300 on YouTube.
Right. On Twitter, wow.
Yeah. They're the official licensors in Southeast Asia. I
want to say. Is it Aniplus? That's Muse Asia.
Oh, that was Muse.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, it disappeared. We minimized something. Okay, there we go. The stream is just... But I'm pretty sure Aniplus Asia is legit.
Yeah, they are. They're like a streaming service.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're going to probably have to put season 3. Yes, NBC Universal. Yes. Yeah, that's...
9 hours and
38
seconds.
Oh no, this is the.
Did they just upload their entire season?
They did. That is legit a full catch up.
Yes.
Wait, this is. Yeah, this is 3.
Yeah. Okay. We've seen the Toei Animation One Piece stream here. That just is 24/7 streaming One Piece. I don't know why more anime companies don't do that, because
One Piece even puts it up on their YouTube for 1 week, each new episode, which is kind of crazy. But yeah, no, New Gate, man.
Yeah.
Like it's not gonna blow your mind, but it is. It's a very cool kind of double mystery, and I'm sure they won't get to it the series, but eventually we do find out that there was an Asuna character as well.
Oh, okay. Because from your description, I think even like Sword Art Online did something semi-similar, not like completely one, but it was just like one episode at the end of Alicization where Kirito gets stuck in this game worth like 1,000 years.
Yeah, that's the end. And then his clone kind of comes out. Interestingly, like the antagonist from the next two arcs.
Yeah. Like I like that direction Sword Art Online went, so if this is like kind of...
Yeah, this is literally the end of season 1.
Yeah. Right?
Or season. You know what I mean? Episode 14.
Yeah.
Our microphones aren't muted.
That's not the end of the world. We haven't said anything horrible.
No. Just talking more about.
I love isekai. Wow. I love Sword Art Online. You can hear. Hey, chat. How are you doing?
Hi, chat. We didn't realize the mics were live, but it's totally cool there.
Yeah, we're just nerding out over isekai chat, don't worry.
Right now we're going to turn into a ASMR channel. You can listen to the sound of turning pages.
Yeah.
My mellow dulcet tones.
Okay.
I'm talking.
Hello, right hello. Now. Are we live right now?
Are we live? Are we talking?
We all good. We all good.
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay. How many do we have left? We've gone through quite a few.
Yeah, we're not dragging our feet too bad.
No. Sorry? That's a great. I actually wanted to, these are actually way more comfortable than the pants I was that I was wearing. Is it the camera mic? I took off the audio. Okay. Yeah, it's probably the cameras.
It's all good. So yeah, well, we got like three pages.
Yeah,
it's not bad. I say when I look 27.
It is certainly a long season. Although I swear to God, they keep getting longer and longer. I remember like 3 years ago, it was like, oh, I watched 30 trailers, and that's good.
Oh, it was so nice. Honestly, that was the best part. Right
there, yeah,
watching the half the.
Are you kidding me? Right. Because I remember I would, I also sometimes do like trailer watch streams as well on my own channel. And when I started this, I started doing it about like 5-6 years ago, I'd do it in like 2 hours. All right, we're done now. And now it's like, sometimes I can go up to like 6 hours for some seasons. It's because I watch like every single trailer that's come out, and it's multiple trailers for like each show.
Wow.
And I read the synopsis for each show as well, and it is just like one working day if I want to go through a I want to go through a anime chart.
And we're okay. Back.
well, hope you enjoyed our back talk chat.
Yeah, we're back. And we're going to switch real quick to the many sides of voice actor radio, which I think is about seiyuu who pretend to like each other on their like variety program, but can't actually stand each other.
Okay, that is.
Say something
funny.
Which
something funny.
Something funny.
I said something.
Was at the very bottom there, Nabil? Up one.
I can't find it on the. Did we skip
here.
It? It was back. Okay.
Yeah, this is the only one that we actually skipped.
Okay, over. The many sides of voice actor radio.
Yeah. We don't have any sound.
We have no sound. When you went on your muting spree.
Yeah.
Well, I'm down for an anime about radio shows.
Yeah. Have you ever been on a...
Ironically
muted.
Oh, wait.
Okay. Well, we're doing troubleshooting here. We're good.
Yeah. Thank you.
There we go.
Okay, there we go. That
there we
sound.
Go. We were all on standby, but now we are on air. You know, so that like Yaru is back.
I'm not complaining, by the way. Okay. I'm not complaining.
Yeah.
I mean, I think Maren Kitagawa was like such a I think she started a big trend in the Garu character designs.
Yeah. Oh no. So they're going to end up like finding a way to be friends despite this, or...
It all leads back to idols. It always does.
There's a friend in the middle.
Okay, I'm confused.
Yeah, I'm also quite confused.
Is this a radio anime? Is this a voice acting anime? Or is this an idol anime?
Yeah.
Or is it all three?
Especially since they... Yeah, and they seem to be like on a... Like that was like a high school club is what it seemed to be.
Yeah. But...
She looks a lot like Mara now that you pointed it out. Like... So they're like a singing idol duo.
Yes.
Also do voice acting and are on a radio show.
Off as
and
a...
are school classmates.
Yeah. Is this an anime original?
I'm not sure.
I would. Either that's a lot of story development to cover, or this is an anime original with everything planned out beforehand.
Right, where they can show.
Yeah.
Right.
Because otherwise, that's a lot that happened in the first three episodes. You start off with a school, right? Doing a radio show, move up to a voice actor, and then have your first idol debut.
Right.
Okay.
Wow.
Manga and a light novel. Okay.
Right. I'm not too big a fan on idol anime, but the voice acting and radio side of things does have me interested.
Yeah.
It's one of those where, like, there's so much in that trailer that I have no idea what the actual shape of the show is.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's about their, like, individual rivalry or what, really. It's kind of all over the place. Yeah.
All right.
This next one is third season, final season. Yeah. The manga has ended of The Duke of Death and His Maid. Shout out to our reviewer, AJ, who adores this show. So
he's not wrong.
He's not wrong.
No, I mean, I'm a manga reader, but
yeah.
It's a very cute show, but does a good job of handling its heavier themes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Garn, are you familiar with it?
I am not familiar with this one,
unfortunately. Okay, so like the main male character, the Duke,
can't
physically touch anyone because it'll kill them, right?
He literally will kill anything he touches.
Right.
Thing, person, whatever.
Yeah.
Like even gloves.
Right, okay. Right.
Yeah, and it's kind of this interesting love story between the two.
So he permanently has to like hover hands with every.
Well, yeah, like she's always constantly invading his personal space and getting on it.
Yeah.
And he's like, "Don't touch me or die," kind of thing.
Yeah.
But you know, it's a thing. But you learn more and more about the curse, about families, about everything, about the subsequent like extended cast, and it's a their love stories, and it all kind of goes back to him. And he does get, at least in my memory, like I haven't read it in a long time, but there are certain moments where you're just like, he gets his badass moments,
right?
Okay. You know, everybody gets their real big damn hero moment.
Okay,
even though it's mostly low key for a lot of the show.
Sounds like a very cute little show.
Yeah, apparently a lot of the big turnoff for people was the 3D CG.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's a sad reason not to experience that story, in my opinion.
Yeah.
But the manga exists.
So, yeah. All right. This next one, I'm sure, is highly anticipated by a lot of people. This is the third season of Konosuba.
Of course. It's good to have the gang back again. We had the Megaman spinoff like two years ago or something like that.
Because last year I went to the stage show for it. So it was about 1 year ago.
Okay.
That was the explosive world. Yeah.
Explosions upon this wonderful world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have not watched any of this. This is on my backlog. I've heard it's really funny.
The best way I can describe this is Always Sunny in Philadelphia. But isekai version.
Oh,
that's
really?
Not a bad way of saying it.
Yeah.
It's a group of people who are
terrible.
Terrible people? Terrible people. I wouldn't, but they're not like malicious.
Okay. Yeah.
None of them are malicious.
Yeah.
Okay.
But they all have at least some kind of personality flaw that really makes them pretty terrible.
Yeah.
But they do find a a family. They make a family.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh no, the Demon King.
Because, like, the whole thing is he's supposed to be a hero,
yeah,
and he just stays in the first town.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
And never leaves.
Yeah.
Like, just stick around in the starter town.
And yes, and yeah, never yeah, ever yeah, leaves. Like, that's the point. I mean, briefly yeah, leaves sometimes, but, you know, I mean, never leaves. It's kind of the
idea. Honestly, the biggest thing that stands out to me about this, because it is a comedy anime, but they have, like, the chemistry down.
Oh, yeah.
Especially the voice actors and actresses.
Oh, yeah.
They will ad-lib sometimes, and the fact that they're given that freedom to just kind of like do what they want just adds so much to, it's almost like a real life sitcom where,
oh, okay, yeah, yeah, and they're so comfortable with the characters,
right, yeah,
at this point, right?
And they yeah, do and the thing is like they're all as selfish as they all are in their ways,
yeah,
like the comedy and them being such bad people actually makes the feeling moments, like the real powerful moments where they're like,
yeah,
they put all that away and like have a real human connection, those moments like really do hit hard,
yeah,
when okay, they're supposed to,
yeah,
like the movie does an amazing job of that with like there's two rival magician girls who like they're rivals the whole time, they treat each other like crap.
I mean, it's kind of like that sitcom moment where you're like, oh, I was watching this for laughs, and now I'm like really like feeling emotional yeah, now.
And they do really like the characters yeah, all have like they're all complex enough.
Yeah, yeah.
Despite their kind of big flaws, one note yeah, flaws, that eventually like you'll get those surprisingly feeling moments.
Yeah.
There. Which really adds to it. You know?
Yeah. Yeah, highly recommend Konosuba for anyone who isn't watching it.
Although I would say I have a real problem watching it week to week. It's one of the ones that like
you'd like to binge.
Have to binge it.
Yeah.
Because if not, I kind of get like, I don't know, burnt out almost.
Yeah, I'm not a weekly watcher myself. I'm definitely a binge watcher. Even if I'm following anime seasonally,
yeah,
I need like at least 4 episodes to Jones, watch in one go. Okay. Otherwise, I'm not gonna follow it. So yeah, I completely agree with you on that.
Yeah, because I mean there are story arcs in it, and it does feel good. Like if you do it arc by arc,
yeah,
it always does feel yeah, really good.
Yeah.
All right. We're gonna take a quick ad break to show an ad from Viz Media, one of our supporters for the trailer watch party.
Nakama, there are 3 new One Piece titles that released this month, Volume 105 and 2 spin-offs. The first spin-off series is One Piece, Ace's Story, which follows the origin story of Fire Fist Ace, featuring art by the Dr. Stone mangaka, Boichi. The volume also includes a bonus chapter featuring Zolo and a double-sided color poster. The second spin-off is One Piece, Shokugeki no Sanji, which is served up to you by the creators of Food Wars. It includes 6 original stories featuring Straw Hat Chef Sanji. Make sure to check it all out on Viz Media.
All right. We're heading into kind of the last run
yeah,
trailers here. We're getting here pretty close to
yeah,
the end.
Yeah,
pretty
so close.
Now would be a good time to start thinking about the trailers that stuck out to you most for your top 5.
I already have a few that I'm really interested in.
Yeah.
But so we still got some more to go and some big titles that I can see from this list.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, we still got some big ones left. This next one is giving me Vampire Night vibes. I guess it's about time to come back around to Vampire Shoujo again. So this is Vampire Dormitory, about an orphan girl who disguises as a boy and is saved by a vampire and becomes a subservient thrall. So she can live in the boys' dorm.
Wow.
That's like Hanasaku and
yeah, yeah. I was like Hanasaku
yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Isareteiru onna no ko no chi wa amai ichigo no aji ga shite. Sore wa tamaranai nda tte. Okay.
Okay, so now we know.
Yep.
Yeah.
Kisses taste like lemon.
Yep.
Blood tastes like strawberries.
There we go. There we go.
Anime teaches me so much, you guys.
Oh, oh my.
At least. I'm sorry. He's like classic vampire. He's got a cape.
Yes. I was not expecting the cape.
Yeah. You think, like, I feel that's like standard issue. You become a vampire, you get a cape.
but I feel like I've just woken up 20 years ago. This is this is such an old school anime feel. Oh my god.
Sorry. Like the guy's like, are you aware that he's a vampire? Yeah, bro. He's like literally wearing a cape. Yeah. The time. Was anyone not sure of that? All right, that was pretty short. I don't know. I'll probably watch an episode of it.
Yeah. Oh,
we're being honest.
I'll hit up my
safe space, right?
Yeah.
I'll hit up my man. Be forced to watch an episode
yeah,
of it.
Will. Yeah.
I will be watching an episode for my own channel as well, but I'll probably hit my manager up, Maylin. That seems like her kind of show.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god, I feel like I have woken up 20 years ago because I just saw the next title that we're gonna be watching as well.
Next title. Oh my. Similar vibes. Black Butler is back. Everybody remember when everyone at cons were where they all the girls had the that one dress, it was like black and pink with all the ruffles and the girls
yes right
yeah. Black Butler, the public school art.
Now correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't Black Butler one of the ones that had like an anime original ending and then they was on back?
Season 2. Yeah.
Okay, because I remembered like something about that where like the last time they restarted it taking that ending away.
Yeah, because I haven't caught up personally, but everyone's told me that season 3, Book of Circus, was like, okay, now we're going back to the manga now. This is good. And this is a continuation of Book of Circus, from what I understand.
I mean, this looks gorgeous.
Yeah.
I think fans don't have anything to complain about as far as like what the production looks like.
I'm trying to think, when was the last time I watched an anime that had like, that was based on a manga that had like an original ending in it?
Oh yeah.
And then they just like retconned it?
Yeah, that used to be done.
No, I remember so many when that was the norm.
Yeah.
And then modern anime is just like, hey, let's just cut it off. We don't need an original ending.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, what? Who needs an ending to this anime anyway?
Yeah.
We'll get a second manga season or we won't.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Looks like a lot of handsome guys.
Yeah. Now the trend is, hey, remember this anime that everyone forgot about 10 years ago? Let's just do a sequel out of nowhere.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sure, like with this.
Yes. Oh no, he's gonna get Seal's getting hazed, guys.
But you know what it is? You know that brand recognition. Like you heard, I've never seen an episode of Black Butler. Yeah. I know what Black Butler is.
Yeah, yeah.
Clearly brand recognition works.
Yeah.
Yes.
Time to make a sequel.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry, the goth one blowing bubbles.
Hey man, if Data Law can get 5 seasons, Black Butler can come back with 4 seasons, yeah. Man.
Right.
Yes, my lord.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah, there's Sebastian. There's,
they were like, he don't even need to be in the trailer.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You get one line. That's enough. That's yeah. That's all you get, girls.
Yeah, yeah.
Watch the show.
We'll probably like day before release, just a Sebastian-centric trailer.
Yeah.
I hope this also spawns a whole bunch of new AMVs. You know, right? This is like AMV era.
It is.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That'll.
For something completely different, the next one is called Grandpa and Grandma Turn Young Again. And that's what it says on the tin. Basically.
I've been looking forward to this one,
yeah,
actually.
This one's very cute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, how often do you get an anime where the main characters are an old elderly couple?
Not
yeah,
you know,
yeah, like I mean, I might have earlier on kind of complained about like slice of life,
yeah,
but this is different, like, yeah. This is like there's a big enough twist,
uh-huh,
that makes it interesting.
I'll give this one a pass,
yeah,
this does look pretty cute,
yeah,
and it's funny, it's so great with them, like they look as they did when they're young, they just have white hair,
yeah,
but
yeah.
They're still old people, so yeah. They're still holding out, they're like they're still chilling with their old old people friends.
Kabe Don.
Yep.
Your heart survived Kabe Don at that age.
And yeah, their granddaughters are rooting for their grandparents.
Also, it's just a wholesome idea just to have this old elderly couple who still love each other after how many years of marriage?
Yeah.
Oh.
and they're farmers, right? Like apple farmers.
Yeah, like apple farmers. Yeah.
And it's and it's like, how do I put it? Way, like, you know, they're from a different age where like they didn't do PDA and they didn't do these things, but now that they're young again, they have a chance to not only but to be in love outwardly the way they always were in.
Yeah.
I think I'll watch this with my husband.
Oh.
Yeah, that looks really cute.
Yeah, and have them have young people voices but talking like old people.
Yeah, yeah. I was gonna say there's probably the way the speech goes.
Yeah,
like that as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very excited for that one. And this one as well.
Yeah, so this next one, you know it. Richard, we had some conversation off camera a bit ago about the recent plot turns of the slime anime. But...
I have to say we can't treat him like a good guy anymore.
Yeah.
No.
When you genocide 20,000 people, it's time to accept that we're rooting for the bad guy.
Is rooting even the right verb there?
I think that's kind of like what I found interesting about the, you know, the second season, where the, you know, the first season and the way this anime and manga started was like, oh, this is a nice wholesome,
he's gonna make friends with everybody,
he's just gonna make friends with monsters. And then, you know, he gets this reality check and you're like, wow, okay, I guess this went in a direction that I never expected it to go.
Yeah,
especially when he starts making contracts with demons and eating people's souls.
I'm like, god damn. Okay, I guess we're doing this now.
And don't get me wrong, I say that objectively, but like from the objective, he's a horrible person, but we have been with him long enough to be like, we understand his motives, we empathize with him. You know, we're that's why I say we still root for him,
right?
But we can't pretend like he's the sweet little snowflake
at
the start.
No,
and not a cute not little cinnamon roll anymore.
Yeah. Well, he literally became a demon lord, so
All right, let's see the trailer for season 3 of That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime. And season 3.
Yeah, I mean,
we've in the middle since the last season, we've had a movie and an OVA series. Both original, but did an interest, like they were clearly set at a specific point in time so that they could stealth introduce some characters that'll become important soon.
Yeah, I mean, the thing that really stood out to me about this title originally was it turned into like more of like a kingdom kind of building, like a civilization kind of anime. Which is the part that interests me more rather than like any of the action scenes or any of the individual war scenes. It's more of like the political aspect of things.
Because it really is what happens when you have a country of monsters. But this one's doing good. We're bringing in people who could, at least in theory, hurt the main character.
Oh, okay. Does everyone have a horn in this?
They were ogres, and now they're oni. They've leveled up.
So they were goblins at some point. There are some goblins.
The goblins are now high goblins.
I watched some of season 1.
But I'm interested to see where it goes.
Because
at this point, he's so overpowered.
I've heard he gets ridiculously, like, even more overpowered.
This point, like, he's one of the, seven strongest beings in the world, probably more than that. And it's just kind of like, okay.
All right, where are we going to go from here?
Especially when, like, I believe the strongest is, like, best friend is his best friend. So it's kind of like.
Yeah, one of the strongest is his best friend.
Actually. Both Milam and the dragon.
The dragon,
Both of them are supposedly top tier. So
Well, I've read ahead in the manga, and they have they do add this like extra layer with like, you know, demons having different colors, being like primordial demons and being like some of the first and strongest demons there are. So just because they're not on like the council doesn't mean that there aren't other strong demons out there.
Okay.
So Yeah,
and then there's the other side. There's the clearly there's an angelic presence,
yes,
and stuff like
yes,
that.
That's, yes, exactly.
That is, you know,
yeah,
the natural rival. Yeah. So,
like from what I remember, we're getting to the point where we're introducing every single faction that is going to be relevant coming up, in this kind of like wider world of slime. Mm. So I'm curious to see where it goes from there as well.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This next one's not fantasy at all. This is a Yuri series. It's going to be streaming on HiDive called Whisper Me a Love Song. So
ooh.
It's about a girl who...
is this a Yuri or Yuri Bates?
I'm pretty sure it's Yuri. I think the trailer will make it pretty okay. apparent here. Yeah.
Kind of like Bloom Into You, but with a rocker girl?
Yeah. I think it's one of those things that maybe starts out as like an admiration for her
yeah.
ability, but then it develops into more of a romantic situation. Mm. That one didn't really, like, the key visual, I'm pretty sure, shows nearly kissing sort of
right.
sort of thing.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm also under the impression that it's not Yuri Babe, it's yeah. Yuri.
Full Yuri. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So I'm looking forward to that one. The trailer didn't really give a lot away.
Yeah, yeah. Unfortunately there wasn't too much to gauge on that trailer.
Yeah.
I mean, like I said, I like rocker girls.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I'd be interested.
It's got good music too.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. yeah.
This next one is called Studio Apartment, Good Lighting, Angel Included. Because, you know, when you go to buy an apartment, you know, bonus angelic being, I guess, is a plus.
Because it needs to be a fantasy to be able to buy an apartment,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, I'm kind of wondering if this is another, like, built-in magical girlfriend sort of thing.
Because
there was a couple other apartment
yeah,
yeah. sort of ones like this, right?
Actually, yeah.
Her general design is cute.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, obviously he lives alone.
Yeah.
What was that other one? There was another one that was sort of like the angel next door spoils me rotten.
Yeah.
Yeah, although that was a metaphorical
yeah.
angel, but yes.
yeah.
Yeah. This one actually seems like an actual angel.
What was it? The alien girl from the moon.
Galaxy next door?
That
was another one.
There's so many.
This is a
trope.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the genre is girl falls into this guy's life and she becomes perfect wife material.
Yes.
Stay at home wife material. Yes.
Especially,
yes.
right?
Yeah.
Although this guy I don't know if he's even an adult necessarily. I couldn't tell if he was coming home from a job or if he goes to school or like
yeah.
it's one of those things where my parents are away on business kind of deals.
Forever.
Right?
Yeah.
Forever. Yeah. Yeah.
What an easy writing crutch that is.
Yeah, yeah.
Just like, we don't want to write parental characters and we don't want parental supervision in our story.
Yeah.
They're on a trip to America and they've just ditched their high school age son.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Every
yeah.
day. I know all kinds of people like that.
Yeah. This next one is the second half of the sequel season for The Misfit of Demon King Academy. Mm,
yeah. Second season had one heck of a troubled production, too.
Yes,
yeah,
I heard about that.
Yeah, they had to stop halfway through and then
come back the next season.
Come back the next season and
just
re-air it.
The voice yeah. actor, right? Or did they change the main voice actor
they
as well?
They did change the voice actor, but I thought it was before. I thought it was a COVID thing.
Okay,
yeah, I thought
okay.
it might have been related to COVID.
But they did recast the voice actor, but that happened before the start of
the okay,
season.
Okay.
Was Sugita the voice actor for that?
I don't
remember. I don't
remember. Off the top of my
okay.
head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah. The funny thing about this one is, like, I didn't even. I reviewed this. I didn't even realize it was a second one.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it was such a concrete ending. I was like, oh, I'm sure another season will come. But I was still like, I was like, really? It was already announced that it's going to go on. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Because boy, was it a set ending.
Yeah. Like it, yeah, I very much enjoyed the first season of this. Haven't caught up to the first half of the second season yet.
I think you'll like it. The thing that it did is I remembered while watching the original first season that there was a plot hole in there that I thought it was just lazy writing.
Right.
And it's not. It's actually like
Okay.
It was like a huge, and they do bring it up. Like, they actually pointed out later on in the show. And it's a very interesting story, the first half of the second season was.
Yeah.
There was a character design in there for a demon. He kind of looked like Mephisto from Blue Exorcist, only more designed, if that's possible.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I was a big fan because this was one of those OP main protagonists, but they definitely play into that. I think the only reason I haven't watched the second season yet is because I think Eminence and Shadow also did that so well that they gave me my fix of just here's something super self-aware, just have fun with it. And I'm like, all right, I'm satisfied now.
Yeah. And it's still, just so you know, second season continues the same thing with the the iconic line, what, you thought death would kill me?
Yes. You think death would be enough to kill me?
That kind of stuff continues on. But it is a fairly good mystery, lots of stuff about the past.
Okay.
And like what happened in that 1,000-year chunk. It's a very good, solid story that it was a real shame that it got like truncated in the middle and then we had to wait a season.
Yeah.
And they restarted it. Like, they didn't even pull what they pulled with Nier, where they just were like, here's the rest of the episode.
Yeah,
we had to start
100
over.
Yeah.
Right.
I feel like it got the wind knocked out of its sails.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Okay.
That can really hurt it. Yeah. As far as audience retention.
Right.
Yeah.
So yeah, here's hoping. Like, I'm excited to see where it goes. I mean,
yeah.
Do you like Anos? Congratulations. It's more Anos.
Yeah.
That's pretty much all you need to know.
This next one is about professional cycling, women's professional cycling. It's called Rinkai.
Okay.
I think it's original, but it's one of those ones where there's a lot of merchandise opportunity tie-ins.
Of course,
right?
Of course.
Every bike shop in Japan is our sponsor.
Yeah.
Now that's the CG I don't like.
Yeah. I mean, it looks fine, but if the climax of the series is going to be based on CG races, then I don't know if I can buy into it as much, unfortunately.
But I don't know, have we had an anime about the track bike racing? Like, we've had
Yarimushi Pedal, which is like road bikes.
But that was road bikes, right?
Yeah.
But
not so much track bikes.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm done with that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I did enjoy Yarimushi Pedal. But like I said, if the CG looks like that, it makes it a hard sell.
Yeah. And again, it wasn't a great trailer for kind of selling you on like any kind of personal drama.
Yeah, it was like bikes.
Yeah.
Yeah, bikes. Here are
pretty girls and bikes.
Yep.
Yes, yes.
Watch.
All right. This one's self-explanatory. This is Mushoku Tensei season 2.
Part two.
Rudeus is, you know. Rudy's gonna Rudy.
Rudy's gonna Rudy. Be a creep.
Be a creep. Yeah.
But
this next arc is pretty good.
Is it?
Are
you a light novel reader?
Manga reader.
Yeah. I mean, I think they made a very brave decision to explore what they explored in the previous season, which
erectile dysfunction.
Yes. I mean. I mean, I've seen a lot of plot developments before. I did not see erectile dysfunction coming as a kind of like exploration, but I thought it was like very interesting.
I thought it was very well handled.
Yeah,
the trauma of it made sense.
Yeah.
Like, if anything, I think Mushoku Tensei has always been really good about the trauma that he's going through. Like, his life is 100% like this is a reaction to the trauma he faced in the past.
Yeah. Okay.
And sometimes he gets over it and sometimes he doesn't. Yeah. And yeah. sometimes he falls back into old habits.
Yeah.
But yeah. I do think, but he certainly is growing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I think that's why I love Mushoku Tensei as like one of my favorite isekais, just because, you know, with like the erectile dysfunction thing, I didn't expect it to go there.
Yeah.
But I really like the way they handled it, because it just has the kind of like, it has the confidence to be like, hey, we're going to explore something that not many other people would dare to explore in terms of yeah. depression right. and they're like, trauma. Okay,
here's the jokes for it.
Yeah.
But also, like, this is a real thing that
yeah.
traumatizes and hurts people. And then the effect of it also continues to hurt people.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, it's like this thing. It's just a pile on of, like, horribleness.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, it's I did enjoy that. Yeah, you can treat it as a joke, and you can also be like, yeah, kind of serious thing too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
With Mushoku Tensei, at least for me, it's it has a, let's call it a hard learning curve to get over to get into the story.
Yeah.
As well. I did a lot of research sort of about the plot, because it was so divisive when it first came out. And it's like, how much of this is, you know, people blowing something out of proportion that's a little controversial versus, you know, something that is really difficult to kind of stomach, I guess, from a story standpoint. For me yeah. personally, no, but yeah. I can understand, like, you know, some of the story points that it's dealing with, and definitely the production values have stayed really high.
Yeah,
I've
always had the philosophy where, even though I really, really love Mushoku Tensei, I can totally understand right, how hard it is to like get through some of these moments, and it's more of just like, yes, for me, I can definitely tell that there are some things that are very, very uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, do you have the ability to look over some of these uncomfortable aspects to really appreciate some of the fantastic storytelling that is going on elsewhere as well?
Right.
And a lot of people can't. And I'm just like, okay, that's completely fine and yeah. understandable. I totally understand.
At the
myself.
End of the day, it's entertainment.
Yeah.
So it's right. like, what do you want to use your time right. on as
yeah.
far as and like stories go,
exactly.
right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think those aspects are played 100% straight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like it's not like a fan service scene isn't there for fan service. It's there because that's what the character does.
Yeah.
Like, he is not a good person.
No,
yeah. like he's not. He, yeah. he is not and still isn't.
Yeah.
He does have, but then again, nobody's ever 100% good or bad.
Right.
And it is an unabashed look at this character.
Yeah.
And yeah. Like, I mean, that's the thing that I do love about the anime is it's 100% all in on what it is.
Yeah.
It's not going to sugarcoat anything. It's not going to change things to be better for the anime viewing audience. Mm-hmm. It's not trying to be more popular. It's trying to be what it is.
Yeah.
Right.
And I don't know if we get a lot of art that way these days.
Yeah. Yeah.
And yeah, I've talked a lot about Mushoku Tensei. I love it. But I can understand if that's not the show that you can kind of watch.
Oh, there's certainly moments where I'm just like, oh God.
Yes, same here.
Yeah.
Same here. Just like, yeah. oh, just look away. Just look away.
All right. This next one, Richard, I think this is one that you were particularly hyped for. I'm interested in this one as well. This should be Go Go Loser Ranger.
Oh, it is.
Ooh.
So the main character in this is like a...
He's a member of the Putty Patrol.
Yeah, yeah, he's like a goon, right?
Yep.
Now, in the world itself, is it like the Sentai heroes are they TV show heroes, or are they like real heroes, real monster sort of situation?
Yes.
Okay. 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 we can keep the card close to our chest on it too, but if that makes it better going in.
Oh, right. Like I don't like the quote unquote twist is
yeah.
will easily be in the first episode, okay. if not the first 5 minutes.
Right.
Oh, okay.
So I don't feel any like I have to hide spoilers.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just basically the I guess I can say the twist. So if you want to go in completely blind,
cover your ears for a minute. Yeah.
But basically, the idea is that the Rangers won. This is 10 years later after the enemies came. And the Rangers won after the first year.
Oh, right. Okay.
And so from that point on, every week, the putties are basically forced to come to Earth, pretend to be the newest big monster of the week, and get murdered by the heroes.
Okay,
and then they reincarnate back up on the ship. But the thing is, they feel the pain. Like, they're basically being tortured. And so the whole society is based on this, like, putty genocide complex.
And the Rangers that are kind of like masochistic.
They're all horrible people. Yeah. Very different ways. None of them are good people. They're sadistic.
Sadistic.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, and some of them are truly like sadists, and some of them are just selfish assholes. But and it's about this putty who decides that since shapeshifting is their only ability, he's going to infiltrate and kill the Power Rangers, basically. Okay. But he knows nothing about Earth. He knows nothing about, like, what that would mean.
Uh-huh.
And it's this very interesting story that deals with him, like, in his undercover thing and his mission to kill the Power Rangers.
Yeah.
And I would say that if you want, like, feeling, and this is kind of crazy, but it feels mostly like Chainsaw Man.
Okay.
He's a very kind of, like, dingy?
Dingy.
Dingy, yeah. You know, being this, like, he knows nothing.
Yeah.
Like, he's an idiot.
Okay.
But he thinks he knows more than, but he has his goal, no matter how silly that goal is or impractical that goal is, he's going after it.
Okay.
And it's very much like that. And maybe depending on how they adapt it, might even be the same level of gore almost.
Oh, okay.
It is a,
it did look pretty dark what they were showing up there. And I saw some,
I mean, I, from everything I've heard and from everything I've seen, this just seems like The Boys, but with Power Rangers.
I have also heard that comparison.
And I'm just like, And I'm just like, say no more. Yeah. I'm sold. That sounds amazing. And
it is really good. I don't know how far we're going to get, but it's definitely one of those that I if you're at all interested and want to read the manga, do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It has recently reached like the end of the first Uber arc, kind of like how Chainsaw Man's first 100 chapters are the Uber arc.
Yeah.
Yeah. This one has just hit the end of its big Uber arc, so you can get to a good stopping point place if you start now.
Okay.
And boy, it's fun.
I think this one will probably go on my top five list by the end here.
Yeah, that sounds really interesting.
Yeah, that's pretty easy pick.
Yeah, pretty easy pick. Easy pick. All right, this next one is also kind of, we were talking about earlier about them going back 10 years and redoing it. This next,
I feel
one
like
is,
a young little anime watcher again.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah. This should be Spice and Wolf Merchant meets the Wise Wolf.
Oh, I'm so excited for this one.
So is this supposed to be a remake?
It's a remake. Yes.
Okay.
And Holo was a lot of people's first waifu, I think.
I mean, this was like, you talk about a lot of light novel adaptations now that have the main duo that have like a really good chemistry. This was like the OG for me.
Okay.
Where I just really love the chemistry between the main duo.
Yeah.
This is one I just barely missed.
Yeah, I actually missed it as well. Yeah.
Because I remembered, I really liked back in the day Moyuru.
Yes.
And
yes.
Everyone was like, oh, if you like Moyuru, you have to watch Spice Wolf. It's Moyuru, but better. And so,
The economics are supposed to be a big
deal. Yeah, it was.
But I had also heard that it doesn't, like the first Spice and Wolf didn't complete the story.
No.
In any way, shape, or form. And I had always kind of been like, I didn't want to start if I wasn't going to be able to get the ending.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, this is why this Spice and Wolf was like one of the first memes where it was like the anime we've been waiting to get a sequel for, and then it just never came.
Yeah.
And we waited like years and decades for season 3, and now we have a remake, which I'm very, very excited for. Also, my good friend Kevin Penkin is doing the music as well. And I mean, I'm a big fan of his work. Anyway, him just being a friend, and he's told me, you know, I've had conversations with him off camera, and he's told me he's worked really, 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 really hard on the soundtrack for this. So I'm very excited to hear what he comes up with.
I really enjoyed
his
work in Made in Abyss.
Yeah.
So that'll be a big draw. All right. So before we get to our last few trailers, we have one more ad for you guys. This is Otsuko again, showing off some of their new clothing line that you can pick up at their website.
Gear up for your next adventure with Atsuko, the ultimate destination for premium anime apparel and accessories. From iconic classics to the latest releases, Atsuko has you covered. Visit Atsuko.com to elevate your anime style today.
Sorry, I don't... Play that again?
Oh.
We're at the end. And they... Oh, okay. All right. All right. So this next one here doesn't really need an introduction. My Hero Academia is coming back.
Yes.
For its seventh season. Again. Yeah. This isn't premiering till May. There's going to be a recap for a couple episodes.
And then
this will premiere. So.
Wait. So, like, are they doing? They're just doing recap episodes for the first part, or are they?
Like the first four episodes are recap. And that's
of like what? Like the whole thing?
I don't know. Exactly.
Why do we need four episodes of recap?
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. I wasn't part of that decision, but I know that's what they're doing. Okay. So the recap starts on the 6th of April.
Okay.
And then the new episodes will be starting in May.
Right.
Yeah.
Well,
that's a thing.
Yeah.
All right. So this is My Hero Academia.
I mean, I've somehow kept up to date with My Hero, the anime.
Me too, yeah.
Me too.
Even though
I don't know how that happened.
Either. Yeah, I don't know how that happened. Even though I've like fell out of love with it for a bit compared to what I originally thought. But then I thought season six was the strongest season.
It was,
quite a while.
Yeah, and I think from my friends that I have that are manga readers, it has been pretty top for a while now,
That's
so that
good.
Makes me pretty excited about everything upcoming past this point.
It was actually the first half of the last season that dropped me off because we hit the thing where we hit the this battle's going to be going on for 10 episodes.
Yeah,
and that's hard enough to keep interesting, but it actually just hit a point where it broke my suspension of disbelief,
right?
Which is crazy for a superhero anime, but it's the fact that when depowered, he can still punch the air hard enough to fly and move.
Oh,
and I'm like, okay, it doesn't matter what your muscle mass is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If we're saying no superpowers involved, I don't care how hard you punch the air.
Yeah.
I don't care how buff you are.
Yeah.
Or how perfect your muscle fiber is. Like,
So
like that got me. Like it was just the little things like,
that
I'm like, you're breaking your world and you don't really need to.
Yeah.
Okay, sure.
For me, it was like I was like out of love with it for a bit, and then I was like losing interest. And for some reason, it was like the cheapest thing. They were like, "All right, let me give you edgy Deku," and I'm like, "I don't know why." I'm kind of like, I don't know why, but this is a bit more interesting than what came before. And then it ended off with them introducing, the American hero. And I'm like, okay, now I want to see more.
like the brooding, the Batman arc of Deku.
Yeah.
Like, that's the one thing that, like, I mean, I know anime is anime, manga is manga, but the art style completely changes in the manga.
Yes.
Right.
Which I loved. And then, and it really didn't in the, in the anime.
Yeah. There are parts, there are action scenes and stuff in the manga that is just amazing artistically, and the anime didn't quite deliver on the same amount. Especially, I felt that way with the League of Villains stuff too.
Right.
Like, it just wasn't as it just didn't have that grittiness.
Yeah, right. Like the maybe it's the color, maybe the addition of color does it, or maybe, but like it's a completely different art style when it's the Batman Deku arc.
Okay.
To the point where, like, literally the final part of that is them kind of pulling him back into the normal art style.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's, his mindset also changing, right?
Okay.
That kind of thing.
Yeah.
And I mean, it was okay on the anime, but it was the thing I'd actually been the most looking forward to.
Right.
And that's always the sad thing when you're looking forward to something and the median just doesn't
I agree. All right, this next one also needs like no introduction. You guys saw it in theaters. They just had a theater run for the first episode of this is Demon Slayer, the Hashira training arc. This is one I did totally fall off of. I made it through last season. I fell off.
Last
season was definitely the weakest season
one
in a
or
while.
Two episodes of the last season.
Yeah.
Yeah.
and then fell off.
Yeah.
I mean, I heard Nezuko finally gets stuff to do, so that might get me to come
does.
Back.
She does.
That was always my biggest complaint. I was like, we have a girl. We have one main girl character, and we keep her in a box, and we only take her out when we need her. Other than that, she's quiet and sits in her little box.
She's really like a Deus Ex Machina type of character, right? Yeah. They bring her out because she's super overpowered and everything, but it would break... It would break the tension if she was out available all the time. All the time. So they keep her in a box.
And don't get me wrong, there are some really great stuff, especially the kind of sibling battle in the entertainment arc. Because a pair of good siblings and a pair of not good siblings.
Yeah, I did like that. Yeah.
And that worked well. I liked that a lot. But,
I mean, Demon Slayer for me, the anime, has always been just about really well animated action scenes that bring the hype. If it just brings that, that's all I really look for.
Yeah.
The last season didn't really have too much great action compared to previous seasons, in my opinion. So
there's also so much yelling. I'm sorry. There's just so much yelling.
There is.
Yeah. It's not just Zenitsu. I'm not just trying to make a dig at Zenitsu. Like the Hashira that was in the last arc that they spent a lot of time with did a lot of the same thing.
That's true. Yeah.
So, this is also coming in May.
I will say this though, I'm okay with don't pad your stuff, you know.
Yeah.
If you only have 8 episodes worth of stuff, only make 8 episodes. I'm okay with that. That is definitely something I'm not against.
Yeah.
I completely agree with that. Yeah.
So we've got one more trailer, but before we get to that, Nabil, if you don't mind, very first video again. This is an ad from one of our sponsors. We want to again thank Viz Media for sponsoring us. So we're going to show this real quick, and then we'll show our last trailer. I should get my
We're getting our top fives ready.
Yeah.
Not cheating if I
right.
All right, we've got one more trailer. This is one of the most
Production
IG is in charge of this. Stream on Crunchyroll and Twitter.
Yeah, that's so weird. I saw that.
Really,
I
didn't know that.
I was like,
all right, all right.
Did I read that right or did I understand that right?
Yeah.
But Elon Musk is buying anime now.
Like us right now, right? Yeah,
this is one I'm totally blind on. I've heard nothing but good things, but have not done any kind of prep for it. I've just been waiting.
This is Kaiju number 8. God, that was gross. Oh, his name's of course his name's Kafka.
Yeah. Look, I'm hyped because this is a Shonen Jump anime, but the main character is in his
30s. Oh, there we go.
Finally, someone who's not in, not a high school protagonist.
Yes. And if I understand correctly, the job he has is basically a kaiju cleanup crew.
Yes.
Right.
So he starts off as a kaiju cleanup crew. This is a well-built kaiju.
Yeah.
But then a mini kaiju infects his body.
Uh-huh.
So he can become this, which is like a mini kaiju.
Yeah.
And then he joins the kaiju defense force, but none of them know that he can turn into a kaiju.
I see.
So it's kind of got this kind of like, you know, Code Geass, you know, who is Zero? Who is this mysterious kaiju person that they're trying to hunt? But, you know, he's part of their team.
It looks pretty gory too.
Yeah, I think Production IG looks like they're doing a great job as well.
Is this Jump or Jump Plus? Or
I think it might be Jump Plus.
I think it's Jump Plus.
Jump Plus. Yeah, that would make sense considering
the gore and everything. I'm hoping there's a lot of really cool monster design in this.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So that's Kaiju number 8. And that's all our trailers for the trailer watch
that
party.
Is everything.
And I want to thank everybody who have stuck around so far. So let's do our top fives. If you're in the chat, let us know.
Does it have to be among these? We skipped one show that I really, really like.
Which one is that?
Sandland.
Oh, yes. Okay. You can include Sandland.
I can. Okay. Then I have my picks.
Okay. Let us know which trailers look the most promising to you. Put your top five in the chat and we will read some of those off. It's what we usually do. Our production team will have to read those off to us. So, All right, let's get started. I usually do mine in no particular order because it's already hard enough to pick five, much less.
Yeah, I just picked five that stood out to me. This is not in order.
Do we want to? We could show Sandland. They have it ready.
If they have it ready, go ahead.
Yeah, Sandland. Make sure it's Sandland the series. That's the important one. Yeah.
Oh, this one. Yeah.
Yeah, this is on Hulu. The first 7 episodes have already dropped.
Yeah, episode 8 might be up today.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or tomorrow, maybe tomorrow morning.
Based on a manga by the late, great, dearly missed Akira Toriyama. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This was not what I was expecting.
Well, I haven't seen much marketing about this at all. I didn't know this was already like out.
Hulu in America, Disney Plus here.
God, you think they'd want to promote this?
But yeah, this is like I was expecting based on the images. I was expecting this is going to be this is Dragon Ball basically.
Yeah.
We have a spiky-haired demon kid. We have, you know, a guy with a jeep. We have this, that.
Yeah.
No, that's not what this is. This is the story of an old soldier trying to right the wrongs of his past, and he has a tank. That's what it is. It's like, yeah. So it's this really actually poignant story about this old man hero. Mm-hmm. And I love my old man heroes.
Right.
Like, I think that's the coolest kind of story. But yeah, and so it's, yeah, a story about, you know, prejudice, mistakes of the past, and like there's some definite World War II weapons of mass destruction themes.
Okay.
And yeah, it's good. Like, watch the first 6 episodes, they're the first arc, and it's so good. Episodes 7 and on are a new arc, completely new.
I'll just marathon this today, I think.
It's so good.
I gotta do this before the new season starts because there's so many shows this season.
it'll hook you. And yeah, it's, you know, if you want some Dragon Ball-esque fights, you get at least one or two good ones.
Yeah.
Richard, can I borrow your page 2? I've somehow lost my page 2 and I'm like, I might be memory holding something. Yeah, if you,
hey, it's your page 2.
It's my page 2. I left it over by the computer.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I highly recommend it. It's not at all what I was expecting. And it's, yeah, an old man hero story. And it just, you know, the old man overcoming any prejudices, you know, helping the world see that it can be a better place.
Okay.
Yeah.
You guys have your top fives?
Right? I do.
Yeah, I do.
Right. Chris, are you looking at the comments so we can do some top 5 shout outs, maybe? Yeah. All right. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Garrett, why don't you go first?
Okay. Well, I tried not to include any sequels.
In my interesting one. Idea. Okay.
Did
I actually?
Yeah. So I, you know, obviously one of my favorites are stuff like Konosuba Mushoku Tensei, but my top 5 new IPs and I guess remakes are Train to the End of the World, Jellyfish Can't Swim in Night, Bartender, Spice and Wolf, and Kaiju number 8.
Nice pick.
Are the ones that,
No specific order.
I literally just went by the order of,
that we came across them.
Yeah. So these are my top 5,
and it's interesting. So 2 of those are original.
I have such a soft spot for originals because that's nothing gets me more hype than not getting spoiled by manga readers. so I know I'm gonna have a good.
I guess that could do it. Yeah.
Yeah. I know I'm gonna have a good anime watching experience.
Richard, what's your top 5?
Pretty predictable. These are actually though in order. For me, yeah, number 1 is Go-Go Loser Ranger, then The New Gate. And I mean, I again, this isn't what I think is going to be the best anime. This is what I'm most looking forward to.
Right.
Those are an important distinction to have, I believe. But yeah, The New Gate, Kaiju number 8, just from word of mouth alone, I'm sure it's going to be great.
Yeah.
Sandland, and then Spice and Wolf, because since I had missed the original Spice and Wolf, that's
I'm very excited for this remake.
My top five in no particular order. I also have Kaiju number 8. I also did mine long ways.
Other side. The boom mic.
Okay. Kaiju number 8. And then my number 2 is Go-Go Loser Ranger.
Okay.
And then Windbreaker, which I guess I'm the only one who picked Windbreaker, but give me the delinquent anime. And then Grandpa and Grandma looked really cute.
That did look very nice. I don't
know if it'll make me cry, though.
Yeah.
And they had some good art production on that one with the background art.
Yeah. Probably would have been my number 6.
Yeah. The number 5, Train at the End of the World, only because I'm betting on it actually being really creepy. And I guess Jellyfish I put down here as a honorable mention.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it certainly deserves that. Yeah. I'm interested to see
what the directing for both of those like anime originals just looked very, very promising,
right?
So yeah, I've got a lot of high hopes for them.
All right, we're gonna read off some of the top fives. I'll come to you. So from the comments section, we've got Adriel Asel has Mashoko Tensei season 2 part 2, Kaiju number 8, Konosuba Spice and Wolf, and Laid Back Camp season 3. Lost Thief has Jellyfish Can't Swim at Night, Whisper Me a Love Song, Go Go Loser Ranger, Windbreaker, and Kaiju number 8. I'm seeing some
That makes sense
already. A lot of Kaiju number 8s.
Muamu Gibran has Blue Archive, Mushoku Tensei, Slime, Konosuba, and maybe Laid Back Camp. We didn't show Idolmaster Shiny Colors, though. That's true. I'm sorry, we forgot Idolmaster Shiny Colors. That was a series of movies that they're now recutting to make a TV series.
Oh, is that what that is? Okay.
Yeah. And then from Demon Hero, Kaiju number 8, Sound Euphonium, Go-Go Loser Ranger, and then Elf Wife. Yeah, we had to skip it because of copyright.
Right.
It would have gotten the YouTube.
Well, we did talk about it.
We did talk about it, but it would have gotten us flagged. We tested it ahead of time. And then from the Jelladoo, we have Laid Back Camp, Konosuba, Jellyfish Can't Swim in the Night, Whisper Me a Love Song, and Go Go Loser Ranger. And then from Yon Hobbit to Michael, sorry if I butchered that, we have Astronaut, Bartender, Glass of God, Go Go Loser Rangers, Mysterious Disappearances, and Sandland. So you got a Sandland.
I did.
Robert there.
I converted Richard. Someone.
Yes. Yeah. So,
Astronaut, though, that's an interesting pick.
Yeah,
that didn't really grab me, but like maybe the comedy of it'll be that, you know, just the right thing.
Yeah,
I think it's just the comedy that very hit or miss for me in terms of comedy.
Right, right, right. We just don't know. Yeah, you won't know until you see, right?
Yeah.
Well, I want to thank everybody for tuning in. I also want to thank our sponsors, Viz Media, Atsuko, and iBuyPower.com for making this possible, and a big thank you to Garn and the Trash Chase Pod for tuning in with us.
Having us here.
Thank you very much for inviting me. This was a lot of fun.
They let us use their studio and everything. It was just really appreciated. So once again, if you enjoyed this stream, check the ANN after show. It's on Tuesday, 6 p.m. Pacific, 9 p.m. Eastern. And
somebody wants to see the PC here.
Oh, yes.
Mori PC.
You want to get like a 360 view of this?
Yeah, that'd be really nice.
Look at that.
No. I have both hands on it. So you can I'm very sorry.
We're going to break something. It's okay.
It's okay.
We just have to make sure it's not the laptop.
So yes, this is the.
So there's that. Yeah. And,
come get your girl.
Who was that again? Which
this is
sponsor?
iBuyPower.com. And then also Atsuko gave us the gear, the great Hunter sweatshirt, Hunter pants,
the bleach
turtleneck.
Spandex turtleneck. No, it's not spandex. Is it spandex?
I don't know. It'll tell you.
It's certainly skin tight. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah. It's great for going clubbing. Okay.
Something I clearly do regularly.
Yeah. It's hard to get a hold of Richard on Saturday night, let me tell you. So thank you everyone for tuning in, and we'll see you soon when I get back from Japan and after I've rested a little bit. We'll have another stream. So thank you again for tuning in. And as always, follow Anime News Network on Instagram or on TikTok. We are on X/Twitter, and we are on Facebook. So look for us there. Until next.
And did you wanna pitch yourself?
Yeah, I mean, Greg, do you need to plug yourself?
You can go to Trash Taste, which is where we're streaming this right now. You can also find me on GigguKZ or just Gigguk online. And yeah, pretty much it.
All right, until next time. Thanks, everybody.
Bye.